Specializing in joint replacements, sports medicine, and arthroscopic surgery, Dr. Young has treated athletes and worked with sports teams from middle and high school to college and professional teams. Call now to schedule your evaluation. Houston Clinic. Research, education, treatment. Houston.com.
When the game goes into overtime. But the game goes into overtime. The choice to enjoy is easy. Bud Light, easy to drink, easy to enjoy. Order Bud Light online today. Enjoy responsibly. Anheuser-Busch Bud Light Beer, St. Louis, Missouri.
There's certain core values that I think we have to all buy into totally, and the first one is faith. You have to believe in something bigger than yourself to be a great football team.
And we thought a miracle at Jordan-Hare was amazing. Oh, my Lord in heaven!
Attitude. Attitude is how we talk to ourselves.
To the 15, 10, go crazy, Cadillac! Go crazy!
Mental toughness. We must have it. It's the secret sauce.
And he's into the end zone! Shivers just ran through a man! McKinney's helmet off.
Integrity is not always getting it right, or none of us would have it. It's really when you don't get it right, what do you do?
45 Bostic, 50 Bostic, racing to the 45 to the 40, breaking and tackle to the 30, to the 20, to the 10, he's gone! Touchdown!
Love, the next core value, is the ability to handle inconveniences that come with relationships. Last is why, which is you. We need the fans. We need the Auburn family.
The atmosphere, the crowd, the roar tonight.
That's what's special about this place. What's special about the Auburn family.
Joseph goes up and over. Joseph is in. Touchdown!
Yes, Auburn holds from 39 yards. It's good. It's good. A loss scene. 15 seconds to go.
Down play for Coyle. Here comes pressure. Down it goes. How fitting is that?
The celebrations begin. Get ready. Tuber's corner. Auburn's coming to run.
They're not going to keep them off the field tonight.
Do you remember me standing right here and telling you when you became one that you'd know it? Then you know it now.
Bama punch, bow over the top, the first time at Jordan-Hare. Go crazy, Cadillac, go crazy. The comeback and the kick six, just a few of the golden moments for Auburn in the Iron Bowl. So what does today have in store on a gorgeous afternoon on the Plains? Time for the 88th renewal of the greatest rivalry in college football. Good afternoon and War Eagle from Jordan-Hare Stadium with Jason Campbell, Will Herring, Paul Allen, Brad Law, Gene Dulaney, Patrick Tisdale, and Ben Harley. I'm Andy Burcham. Hard to explain what occurred last week at Jordan-Hare. The Tigers came into the game with a three-game winning streak, playing their best football of the season. But Auburn was outplayed by New Mexico State in a 31-10 upset. Now up to the Tigers to regroup for their biggest rival of the season. Many left Alabama for dead after its early season loss to Texas. The Crimson Tide hasn't lost since. Alabama will play Georgia for the SEC Championship next Saturday in Atlanta. If the Crimson Tide wins out, Nick Saban's team has a shot at the playoffs. Now, Auburn is 10-6 in the series at Jordan-Hare. Many of those 10 wins coming as an underdog, many in dramatic fashion. Auburn looks for more Pat Dye Field magic today. The Outdoor Alabama Countdown to Kickoff continues in a moment.
Cyber Golden Gable deals are going on now at Lowe's. Right now, get the best deals of the season, like up to 40% off select pre-lit artificial Christmas trees, holiday lights, and more. Plus, get up to 50% off select tools and accessories from brands like DeWalt, Craftsman, and Kobalt. Start shopping today to find these savings in-store and online, because Lowe's knows deals. Valid through 11/27 while supplies last. Selection varies by location.
Hey, it's Amanda, and a little thing I love about the Chick-fil-A nugget trays is that they're so easy for the holidays. They're warm and flavorful. It's always a crowd pleaser. When I put down a nugget tray, everyone is happy.
Hey, this is Brian, and the little thing I love about the Chick-fil-A nugget trays is the joy that it brings to me and everybody around me during the holidays. They're warm, juicy, and delicious.
Cater the holidays with Chick-fil-A today. Available on the Chick-fil-A app. Real guests paid for their testimonials.
It's game day. What do you take to the tailgate? A flat-screen TV? Take it to the tailgate. Your wife's favorite blender? A DJ sound system? With a Ford F-150 truck, you can take it all. With available Pro Power onboard that acts like a mobile generator, you can use F-150 to take your tailgate to the next level. Visit your local Ford dealer today. The Auburn Tigers and Ford F-150. Greatness starts here. See owner's manual for important operating instructions.
With Vizzy's vibrant dual flavors, the vibe is yours to decide.
I'm thinking Vizzy Refreshingly Berry. A round of blackberry lemon at the bar?
Could be good. Maybe Vizzy Vibrantly Tropical.
You always say Vibrantly Tropical.
Come on, a cooler full of papaya passion fruit on the beach?
Oh yeah, that's a vibe. I'm down.
Vizzy Hard Seltzer. Flavor for every vibe. Naturally flavored with other natural flavors. Celebrate responsibly. 2023 Molson Coors Beverage Company. Milwaukee, Wisconsin flavored beer.
You're listening to Auburn Football. Now back to more of the Outdoor Alabama Countdown to Kickoff. Visit OutdoorAlabama.com to find your next adventure. Go hunt. Go fish. Get outdoors.
A sea of blue at Jordan-Hare Stadium today with speckles of crimson and white for the 88th edition of the Iron Bowl. Welcome back to Jordan-Hare Stadium as Auburn gets set to face Alabama. For more than 100 years, Eagles have been associated with Auburn's football program. Today, Aria continued the tradition that is uniquely Auburn by circling the stadium and landing near midfield. Her flight represents the combined efforts of the Auburn College of Veterinary Medicine, the Auburn University Raptor Center, and the U.S. Fish and Wildlife Service in promoting the conservation of all birds of prey. Auburn University marching band about to make its way onto Pat Dye Field. Three drum majors will throw those maces into the turf and will be underway for the pregame festivities at Jordan-Hare. Joined now by Tigers former Auburn quarterback, NFL quarterback Jason Campbell. You look at this game today, and it's response time for this Auburn team after a tough one last week for Alabama. This is just another win that they need to try and keep their playoff hopes alive.
Yeah, Andy, this is a great game for Auburn because you get a chance to show redemption. Last week you came out and you basically didn't show up last week against New Mexico State. And you get an opportunity to come out and play against your arch rival, your biggest rival of the season in front of your home crowd to show them that you are that team that was building the 3 weeks before you played New Mexico State and not the team that showed up last week. So for them, it's a chance to get a bad taste out of their mouth. It's a chance to show up. It's a chance to get out there on this football field and create this atmosphere tonight that should be electric.
Great things are possible when you have the power, performance, and the smart features of a Ford F-150, the official truck of the Auburn Tigers. Greatness starts at your local Ford dealer. Jason, what are your Ford keys to the game?
Yeah, my four keys today, Andy, is Auburn must start fast and create energy. What I mean by that is we got to come out of the gate swinging and going with our best. Like, you can't slowly play your way into this ball game. You got to come out with energy and create it quickly. Next for me, we have to win the line of scrimmage. This game is always won in the trenches. It doesn't matter how many passing yards or anything like that that looks fancy on the outside. This game comes down to the inside in the trenches every year. Offense, you must protect the football. You got to protect the football in this game. You cannot give Alabama's offense a short field the way that they can run the football and throw the football and use Milroe as the RPO guy. Next for me, last, defense, rush to contain today. Don't rush to sack Milroe. He looks to find lanes to get through and try to pick up extra yards with his feet. We got to contain him and keep him in the pocket today. That's how you help Auburn defense and this team win.
It is tempting to go after Milroe. I mean, Alabama has given up 38 sacks this season. That's worst in the SEC. But if you don't get him, you're in some trouble.
Yeah, that's the problem. If you don't get to him, you're in trouble. I know Auburn would probably try to put a spy on him, and I imagine there'd probably be someone like a Eugene Asante, someone that has a hat for the football, someone who's fast, who can also run from sideline to sideline, because Milroe's the type of guy that when he do tuck and run, you still got to be able to tackle this guy. He's big, he's strong, and he's built like a running back for most part of it, but the kid loves to throw the football down the field to Burton, and that's where we got to make sure that we don't give up the big play in our defense, let the secondary let these guys get behind him.
16 of his touchdowns are by 15 yards and out, and 7 are from 40 yards and out. He will chuck it. He will go deep. and we'll try to do that here today.
Yeah, that's because everybody likes to get up inside and play the run game. They like to play the defense and try to contain Alabama from running the football at them. But then when you do that, though, you got to have a secondary that can stop their big play receivers. But for me, I feel like we do have a secondary that can do that. For the most part of this year, our secondary has showed up, except for two games we got beat against LSU and New Mexico State. But other than that, our defense has played good, and they created 17 turnovers this year. The streak broke last week. We didn't create a turnover last week. So I expect our defense to come out today, play extremely hard, and help our offense out by creating turnovers, because we know Alabama loves to control the clock as well.
First down is so key for this Auburn offense. You get third and long with Alabama here today. And, Jason, they're pinning their ears, and they're coming after Peyton Thorne today.
Yeah, you got to contain Dallas Turner. You know, that's the guy right there. Number 15 for Alabama is the guy that has 10.5 tackles for a loss, 7 sacks. Like, he's a guy that can play tremendously, and he can change a ball game in a minute. The next one for me is Chris Braswell. He's another guy that has 9.5. There's 9.5 tackles for a loss and 7 sacks as well. So those two guys are the anchor on that defensive line. But in the secondary, Kool-Aid. Kool-Aid is the guy for me that got to know where he's at. If you're Peyton Thorne, you're passing the football. He already has 2 interceptions so far and midseason All-American.
How does Auburn find it in the trenches when it was not there for the Tigers last week?
Yeah, we got challenged last week. You know, we did not win in the trenches. And I think for this football team, because we didn't win in the trenches, that's an offensive line coach deal that he probably had on the board all week this week. Guys, this cannot happen again. You have got to come out, and you have got to play with energy, and you got to play with an edge to yourself. To beat this offense, to beat this defensive line that we're facing today, you got to come out and put doubt in their minds early that this is going to be a long day, because you got to get that job done if you're those 5 offensive guys up front.
And on the other side of the ball, this is an Alabama team that runs the football well with Jace McClellan and Jalen Milroe, and they're huge up front.
Yeah, they're very big. They're the biggest offensive line in probably all of sports, if you want to go to the NFL as well. 360, 352, 305, 316, 360 again. You know, they're huge guys up front, Andy. But where we can get them at is someone like a Marcus Harris. Their feet is not as fast as how big they are. Marcus Harris can have a big day today, getting off the line of scrimmage and get off the snap of the ball.
God Bless America being sung and played at Jordan-Hare Stadium, the national anthem is next, and then the 88th Iron Bowl. Stay tuned, friends. This is the Auburn Sports Network from PlayFly.
Download the new and improved Auburn Game Day app. It's fully customizable to your interests with the new My Auburn tab. Plus, buy tickets, skip concession lines, be a part of game day giveaways, shop the latest Auburn gear, and get live in-game scoring. Plus, listen to every broadcast from the Auburn Sports Network, even when multiple games are happening simultaneously, on the official mobile app of Auburn Athletics, the Auburn Game Day app. Download it now.
For generations, Alabama Extension has played a vital role in bettering the world around us. And by taking information discovered through Auburn University research to the people, we are empowering communities to tackle the challenges of tomorrow in a rapidly changing world. As educators, Extension is a partner in every county, bringing practical ways to better our homes, farms, people, and overall way of life. Alabama Extension, extending knowledge, improving lives. Discover more by visiting aces.edu.
The Whataburger Sweet and Spicy Bacon Burger is an all-time favorite. It brings so many flavors together in harmony, you might wonder if it's greater than the sum of its parts. It's got 2 all-beef patties, both of which fantastic. Crispy bacon, love that. Grilled onions, melty cheese. I mean, who would say no? And sweet and spicy pepper sauce. Yes, please. I guess we're kind of partial to every part. The Sweet and Spicy Bacon Burger from Whataburger. Just like you like it.
Adventure is waiting for you at Alabama State Parks. So, pack your bags. With so much to explore, there's something for everybody. Whether you're hiking the foothills of the Appalachians or wading into the warm waters of the Gulf, finding a vacation that you and your family will love comes naturally at any one of our Alabama State Parks. To learn more, call 800-ALAPARK or visit alapark.com. This message brought to you by your Alabama State Parks.
This is offensive lineman Cam Stutz, and these are the Yellowwood starting lineups for the Tigers.
Defensive line.
Justin Rogers of Detroit, Michigan, Oak Park High School.
Marcus here, Montgomery, Alabama, Park Crossing High School.
Kildrick Falk, Highland Home School, Highland Home.
Linebackers.
Jalen McLeod, Washington, D.C., Freshman Collegiate Academy.
Eugene Asante, Alexandria, Virginia, Westfield High School.
Austin Keys, Taylorsville, Mississippi, Seminary High School.
Secondary.
DJ James, Mobile, Alabama, Spanish Fort High School.
Neil Maya Preach, Jackson, Alabama, Jackson High School.
Keontae Scott, San Diego, California, Helix High School.
Jalen Simpson, Brunswick, Georgia, Frederica Academy.
Zion Puckett, Griffin, Georgia, Sparta High School.
Offensive line.
Dylan Wade, Houston, Texas, South Falls.
Gunnar Britton, Conway, South Carolina, Conway High School.
Connor Liu, Kennesaw, Georgia, Kennesaw Mountain High School.
Cam Stutz, Killen, Alabama, Brooks High School.
Isaiah Miller, Memphis, Tennessee, Wooddale High School.
Receivers.
Rivaldo Ferrer, Lauderdale, Florida, Boyd Anderson High School.
Jay Fair, Dallas, Texas, Rockwell Heath High School.
Caleb Burton, Houston, Texas, Lake Travis High School.
Corey Moore, Kenner, Louisiana, Archbishop Rummel High School.
Running back.
Jacques Hunter, Philadelphia, Mississippi, Neshoba Central High School.
Quarterback.
Peyton Thorne, Naperville, Illinois, Naperville Central High School.
Special teams.
Reed Hughes, Conway, Arkansas, Conway High School.
Jacob Quattawam, Enterprise, Alabama, Enterprise High School.
Oscar Chapman, Adelaide, South Australia, Prince Alfred College.
Alex McPherson, Fort Payne, Alabama, Fort Payne High School.
The starting lineups have been brought to you by Great Southern Wood, makers of yellow wood pressure treated pine. If it doesn't have that yellow tag, you don't want it.
You've been listening to the Outdoor Alabama Countdown to Kickoff on the Auburn Sports Network. Now, it's game time. Exclusive play-by-play coverage of Auburn football is brought to you by Ford. Visit your local Ford dealer, proud sponsor of the Auburn Tigers. The Alabama Department of Public Health. Don't wait. Vaccinate. Protect yourself and others by staying current on all recommended vaccines. Visit alabamapublichealth.gov/IMM. By Cook's Pest Control and the Centricon System, the unbeatable combination for termite protection. Chick-fil-A. Download the Chick-fil-A app and score big before the game begins. And by Alabama Power, proud supporter of the Auburn Tigers. Alabama Power, power for a better Alabama. Let's go back to Jordan-Hare Stadium with Will Herring on the sidelines. And alongside Jason Campbell, here's the voice of the Auburn Tigers, Andy Burcham.
Auburn University band is in the big AU at the south end of the stadium. Auburn about to emerge from its locker room and getting ready to come onto the field. An explosion of sound as Auburn is about to head out for the 88th Iron Bowl today. Auburn's four captains, Luke Deal, Cam Stutz, Marcus Harris, Elijah McAllister, are already at midfield as we await the coin toss. And Auburn and Alabama getting set to do battle here at Jordan-Hare Stadium, where Auburn is 10-6 since that first game here at Jordan-Hare in 1989. Game day weather forecast presented by Busy Hard Seltzer. Flavor for every vibe. Celebrate responsibly. 64 degrees, mostly sunny skies. Wind out of the east, southeast at 8 miles an hour. Jason, as you came up, you could feel some wind as you were walking through the sands today.
Yeah, that's every time we walk up to the stands, Andy, the first thing I like to do is kind of go and gauge the wind a little bit because you can't really feel a lot of it up here where we at. But down low, there is a little wind circling inside down there. So pay attention to that depending on how far out we're kicking field goals for Auburn and for Alabama.
And here come the Auburn Tigers, followed by the Alabama Crimson Tide. Auburn in the classic home uniforms, the blue jerseys with the white trousers, the classic white helmet with the AU on the side. Alabama white tops and bottoms, the crimson helmet with the numbers on the side. As these two teams get set to do battle in the greatest rivalry, certainly in college football, perhaps in all of sports here today, Auburn and Alabama. Again, Auburn's captains, Luke Deal, Cam Stutz, Marcus Herrera, Elijah McAllister, make their way onto the field along with our Will Herring. My goodness, what must be going through his mind as he heads to midfield for the coin toss today. And today's toss of the coin is presented by Kia of Auburn, where you're always number one.
referee. Walt Hill's our umpire today. This is our coin. Alabama, you're the visiting team, so you're going to call it. This is heads. Auburn, you're the home team. This is tails. This is tails. Call it before I flip it.
Tails.
He's called tails. We're going to let it hit the ground. It is heads. Auburn has won the toss. You're going to take the ball. Which way are you going to kick? Turn this way if you would, please.
All right, boys. Auburn has won the toss, and they want the ball. Offense, let's go. Play some football.
You a little bit juiced down there, Will Herring?
Yeah,
you ready to go?
Just a little bit. If they let me suit up with this COVID year, I was trying to get an extra year of eligibility, but they just weren't hearing it. I don't think I'm good enough anymore.
We're glad to have Will Herring on the sideline today as Auburn gets a set. And interesting, a week ago, Auburn decided to kick it away. Today, the Tigers will take the ball to open the game.
Yeah, and I think Coach Freeze is thinking just like we were a week ago. You got the opportunity to receive the ball in a big ball game or any game. I always like to take the ball first because I always expect my offense to try to go down and get points and put the other team in chase mode. Auburn's not done well this year, and we've had a chance to – we had to come from behind in chase mode early in ball game. So I'm happy that we chose to receive the ball, try to set the tempo. I think a lot of it is Coach Freeze want to get this offense line going early and get these guys rolling. So I like the call to take it first.
So the Tigers will open up on offense against a really good Alabama defense. Sam, a linebacker, is Dallas Turner. Chris Braswell, the Jack. Justin Igboigbe across the middle along with Tim Kennan and Jaheim Otis, that front five that we'll see out there today for this Alabama ball club. Boy, you just can't get in third and long and early today against Alabama.
Yeah, you just hit the key, Andy. You cannot get in third and long. You got to stay in third and short situations. And what that do, it creates the RPO game. That way Peyton Thorne can be a part of our run game as far as keeping the ball on the edges, which he's done well the last part of the season. And then think about getting Jarquez in those third and short yards. You know he loves to run hard. In this ball game, Jarquez would love to run lower his shoulder and remind everybody about Sean Shivers a couple years ago. So this is a game for me. Get in third and short. Stay away from those third and long situations. But like you said, Braswell and Dallas Turner both have combined for 14 sacks between the two.
Brian Battee drops deep to receive along with Jarquez Hunter. That's a little bit of a difference. And they're side by side. Jarquez to the right, Brian Battee to the left in the north end zone here today. And Will Reichard will kick it away for Alabama. And the 88th Iron Bowl is about to get underway in front of a sold-out Jordan-Hare Stadium on an electric afternoon for football. It will be early evening before this game is over, and a cool evening, about 10 degrees cooler than it was a week ago, but a beautiful day for football here today. But interesting that Jarquez is back along with Battee. So Auburn wants two returners back there here today.
Yeah, Auburn trying to put their best playmakers all over the field today. So Jarquez is one of those guys. Like I say, you see him run down on kickoff, but now to be on kickoff return, it just goes to show you that Auburn's doing everything they can today to go out and win this football game. So I like the call. Put your best players in the opportunity to create plays. And also, he may be a distraction for Brian Battee to get the ball. This guy's a legend himself, so I like this.
Reichard will kick it away just inside the left hash mark. Toe to the leather. We're underway at Jordan-Hare Stadium. And Battee about 2 yards deep into the end zone. To the 10, 15, 20, and out to the 24-yard line. Good return by Brian Battee. Brought down by Bray Hubbard, a backup defensive back. And Auburn will have first and 10 at its own 24-yard line.
Yeah, right there, Brian Battee taking that ball 3 yards in the end zone, showing you his explosiveness right there to get that ball to the 24-yard line. Maybe one block away right there, springing that for another 15, 20 yards.
Connor Lute does get the start at center for Auburn today. Tigers quickly to the line of scrimmage. First down from the 24 for Auburn, from the right hash mark. Play action and a rollout by Thorne. Eludes the first man, flips it forward, trying to get it to Lute Deal. And Deal was unable to bring it down. Dante Lawson defending the Will linebacker against the Auburn tight end.
Yeah, Lute Deal right there thought Thorne was going to take it and run. So he turned the block, and then Thorne thought Lute Deal was going to, he was just going to flip it to him and get a gain of three. Just a little bit of miscommunication there.
Second down and 10, Auburn out of the shotgun. And Deal with motion across the set, sets outside the left tackle. Now Hunter in motion out of the backfield. Thorne looks to the Auburn boundary, passes complete, Rivaldo Fairweather, but he was out of bounds.
Yeah, Valdo Fairweather last week had a shoulder injury, questionable for the most part of this week. Good to see him out there catching the ball. Auburn trying to go quickly, trying to get his defense for Alabama, where they don't have a chance to sub and get guys in there fresh.
Here is third down and 10. There's the snap to Thorne. And whistles come in and a flag is thrown. And movement by the Tigers.
False start, offense. Not all 11 players were set prior to the snap. 5-yard penalty, remains third down.
Yeah, that's the thing, Andy. You're trying to go fast. You're trying to keep Dallas Turner and Braswell, those guys, not having the opportunity to get set and create that pass rush that they have. But you got to make sure your guys are set for a full second before you snap that ball.
So third and 15 now for Auburn. The snap, Thorne, empty set, in the pocket, rolls out of the pocket. He's going to run it. Now he throws it, and it's incomplete at the 32-yard line.
Yeah, he got outside the pocket right there. Good job of escaping, getting underneath the defensive end right there, escaping to his right. He was looking for Malcolm Johnson, trying to throw that ball over the Alabama defender there. He had Malcolm Johnson, but just got to put a little bit more height on that, which is easier said up here than down there.
Injured player Terry and Arnold was slow to get up, the cornerback for Alabama, but he jogs off the field. And Auburn three and out on his first drive, and here is Oscar Chapman, averaging 44.7 yards per punt.
And that's what you talked about, us staying out of third and long situation. That third
pass
and long.
Behind the line is under video review. Timeout.
So was he over the line? He may have been on the pass.
Yeah, I imagine Alabama still declined.
It would be a three and out, and Auburn went backwards on the drive thanks to the penalty.
Yeah, that's what we talked about pregame, staying out of these third and long situations, because that's where Alabama thrives at defensively. They're able to get the pass rush on you. They're able to create turnovers because you're trying to force balls into certain places because you're behind the line on those plays. So Auburn's got to do a better job establishing the line of scrimmage. But I understand you want to go fast, but make sure at the end of the day that you're on schedule.
Replay reviews are brought to you by Auburn's Houston Clinic. Don't let a sports injury bench you this season. Go to Houston for your fracture, sprain, or strain, because orthopedics is all they do. Go straight to the specialist. Go to Auburn's Houston Clinic. Jason Autry is today's referee. I think he was across the line if Alabama wants to take the penalty. If not, we'll see Chapman punt it away.
Yeah, if it was a complete pass, they would definitely, you know, take it back. But it being incomplete here, I can't imagine them not just forcing Auburn to punt the ball.
Now the officials continue to talk, and here's the call.
After video review, the passer threw the ball beyond the line of scrimmage. Therefore, illegal forward pass, offense number one. The penalty is 5 yards from the spot of the foul with the loss of down. It'll be fourth down for Auburn from the 15-yard line.
Now they'll take the penalty, obviously. So fourth down and now almost 20 for the Tigers as Chapman will drop to punt this one away.
Yeah, that's a rule change right there. You can add that on until the end of the play. So they added that 5 yards on, which still creates a fourth down situation. It's almost like an intentional grounding type of play.
Caleb Downs to receive this punt for Alabama. He stands at the Crimson Tide 35-yard line. Chapman rolls to his right and punts it away. Downs will let it bounce. It bounces. It takes an Auburn bounce and rolls inside the 35 and settles at the 31-yard line. No return on after the punt of 55 yards. So a good job by Oscar Chapman to get Auburn off its own goal line. And Alabama will have first down and 10 at its own 31-yard line, led by Jalen Milroe, 142 of 214 for 2,267 yards, 19 touchdowns, 6 interceptions. He has 332 yards rushing and 12 more touchdowns. He is flanked by Jace McClellan, 5'11", 212-pound senior from Aledo, Texas, 737 yards and 6 touchdowns this season. Handoff to McClellan right up the middle. He's across the 40-yard line, out to the 43, and a first down for Alabama. Zion Puckett made the stop. The 144th tackle for Auburn and Alabama right back to the line of scrimmage. Milroe drops to throw with time, throws to the boundary. The pass is complete to Jermaine Burton, a senior from Calabasas, California. Nehemiah Pritchett defending for Auburn. It's another first down for Alabama. Two plays, two first downs for the Crimson Tide.
Yeah, Alabama trying to go with tempo, trying to keep Auburn from substituting and getting some odd front looks.
Alabama first and 10 at the Auburn 48. From the gun, Milrow pitches to McClellan to the right, to the boundary. McClellan is taken down at the 42-yard line. Stop made by Austin Keys for Auburn.
A late flag here. Looks like it might be on Alabama offensive lineman. A little extra at the end of that play right there by 65 for Alabama offensive lineman.
That's J.C. Latham, the junior from Oak Creek, Wisconsin, if that is the penalty.
Auburn right now is just watching this early downs from Alabama. We got to make sure we're setting the edge in this ball game. It's going to be a key, not just in pass rush.
Play, personal foul, late hit, run to serve up this offense number 65. 15-yard penalty from the end of the play. It remains second down.
Latham, a preseason first-team All-SEC selection. 6'6", 360, a junior. Jaden Roberts, right guard, 6'5", 350, or 316. The center, Seth McLaughlin, 6'4", 305. Tyler Booker, the left guard, 6'5", 352. And the left tackle is Caden Proctor, 6'7", 360. He's a true freshman out of Des Moines, Iowa. First down back to its 43. They pitch it near side and taken down at the 45-yard line. DJ James takes down number 19, Kendrick Law for Alabama.
Yeah, great job of DJ James right there, coming up from the back end, setting the edge right there, coming up, taking the legs out of Kendrick Law right there. Create a third and long situation here. Auburn, just be smart. Don't get a bad penalty, but also rush to contain. Don't give up lanes to Milrow.
Alabama on third down this season, 50%. A man comes in motion near side on third and 17 from the Alabama 45. Milrow in some trouble, stays in the pocket, he throws wide open. First down for the Crimson Tide near the 30, inside the 30. Number 11, Malik Benson, down near the 21-yard line.
Yeah, this is too much time right there. Too much time for Milrow to sit in the pocket right there. Allow Malik Benson time to get open on a dig route for a gain of 34 yards. Jalen McLeod almost got there, but you got to put pressure on Milrow inside.
13th catch of the year for Benson. First and 10 for Alabama at the Auburn 23-yard line. Low snap to Milrow. Plenty of time. He throws to the boundary. It's complete at the 11-yard line. And a first down to Jermaine Burton. Two catches already on the day. That's 31 on the season for Jermaine Burton, a transfer from Georgia.
Yeah, Auburn going to have to make some adjustment when they get back to the sideline. Maybe have to come with some type of blitz packages to create a little bit of pressure on Milrow. Right now, he just looks too comfortable in the pocket right now.
It's getting a lot of time to throw it, isn't it? Roydell Williams is the tailback, a senior from Hueytown, Alabama, with 49 yards on the season. He flanks Milrow to his right. Send a man in motion. It is Williams up the middle off the right tackle to the 5. Head down near the goal line. He is taken down after a 9-yard gain. Roydell Williams with the carry for 9 yards.
Yeah, Roydell Williams right there running tough inside at offside, running inside zone right there down to the 2-yard line.
Second and 1 for Alabama. On the initial drive for the Crimson Tide, 11:05 and counting in the first quarter. No score, but Alabama is knocking at the door. Williams again into the end zone for a touchdown for the Crimson Tide.
Yeah, that drive just looked too easy for Alabama right there. You get them in a third and long situation where you want this team to be at, behind the schedule and behind the sticks. You cannot allow Milrow to sit back there on third and long like that and let these explosive receivers that they have get that open in the middle of the field right there, convert that third down, which have now turned out to be a touchdown for Alabama.
Second touchdown of the season for Williams. Alabama now, after scoring on its first possession, has won 53 of its last 55 games, including today. We'll find out the final on this one, as Reichert is out for the extra point. James Burnip will hold, and Reichert puts it through. And Alabama takes the opening drive, a big third and 18 completion to keep the drive alive, and the Crimson Tide find the end zone. 10:53 to go in the first quarter. Alabama 7, Auburn nothing, and Auburn football continues in a moment.
What does commitment sound like? At Alabama Power, we hear you, we see you, and celebrate you on long practice days, game days that bring us together, and every day in between. Your commitment to making an impact for the team, for the fans, that inspires us to be at our best for the communities we champion across the state. We're committed to this kind of energy. That's power for a better Alabama. Alabama Power is a proud supporter of the Auburn Tigers.
Things we take for granted, ordinary opportunities for parents and their children, can be a foster child's extraordinary. You have the power to do something positive that will change the life of a young person right here in Alabama. Open your heart and open your home to a foster child today. For more information, visit www.dhr.alabama.gov or call 1-866-4-AL-KIDS. Brought to you by the Alabama Department of Human Resources, the Alabama Broadcasters Association, and this station.
Hey, it's Amanda, and a little thing I love about the Chick-fil-A nugget trays is that they're so easy for the holidays. They're warm and flavorful. It's always a crowd pleaser. When I put down a nugget tray, everyone is happy.
Hey, this is Brian, and the little thing I love about the Chick-fil-A nugget trays is the joy that it brings to me and everybody around me during the holidays. They're warm, juicy, and delicious.
Cater the holidays with Chick-fil-A today. Available on the Chick-fil-A app. Real guests paid for their testimonials.
If SEC football runs deep in your veins, then SiriusXM SEC Radio is what you need to listen to. We're talking conference and team previews, plus hear live games, news, and analysis from experts like Chris Doering, Aaron Murray, and Max Starks. Go in-depth with your favorite team with coaches shows, championship specials, and more. Get inside SEC football like nowhere else. Feed your fandom on the SiriusXM app. Stay up to date anywhere you go. Just download the app and start streaming.
Alabama drove 69 yards in eight plays. It took 3 minutes and 30 seconds. Roydell Williams' two-yard touchdown run, his second of the season. Remember, third and 18 for the Crimson Tide on that drive. And Alabama leads 7-0 with 10:53 to go in the first quarter at Jordan-Hare Stadium. And again, it is Jarquez Hunter and Brian Battee inside the Auburn goal line to take this kickoff from Will Reichert. Near Battee, 5 yards deep into the end zone. He's to the 5, to the 10. Almost taken down, stays down, flags are down. This may be, I don't know, this could be a face mask against Alabama. We'll wait and find out.
Yeah, I think you're right there, Andy. I think it was a face mask. But Brian Battee got to be careful taking that ball out too deep in the end zone.
The call coming from Jason Autry.
During the turn, illegal block in the back. Return team number 44. The penalty is half the distance from the end of the run. It'll be first down, Auburn.
Oh, my goodness. The opposite of what we thought. We were watching a TV copy, and clearly Battee heads, turns. How do you not get a face mask? Because he threw the flag immediately as it happened.
Well, there's no question. He grabbed the cage, and everybody in this ballpark now taking a look at it. Holy cow!
Grab a face mask.
Good night. I mean, he grabbed the side cage of Brian Battee. And they called the flag on Auburn.
As soon as it happened, he threw the flag. I thought he was calling it because of the face mask.
First and 10 for Auburn at its own 4. The handoff. Jarquez Hunter head forward, gets across the 5 out to about the 6.5.
Andy, I just don't know how two refs miss that. How you have the back ref and then have a side ref both right there on that play and you both miss it.
That's amazing. Second down for Auburn. Jarquez Hunter, the Auburn tailback, junior out of Philadelphia, Mississippi. Flanks Thorne now to his right on second down. Thorne hands the ball to Jarquez, makes the first man miss, then driven back. And taken to the turf at the 5-yard line. They'll give him out to the 9 on the play.
Yeah, tough position for Auburn offense right now, trying to have it backed up in your own end zone almost and trying to come out of here out of deep territory. That's why you have to be smart on those on those kickoff returns. I understand that you want to be explosive, you want to be aggressive, but you got to make the decision. When that ball is 5 yards deep, it's probably best to take a knee and get the ball in 25.
Third and 5 for Auburn at its own 9. The Tigers, 34% on third down this season. Man comes in motion. Thorne looks that way. He throws, and it's over the head of Jarquez Hunter, who has a first down if he holds on to the ball. He got a hand on it but didn't bring it in.
Yeah, Peyton Thorne overthrew Jarquez right there, running a flat right out of the backfield versus man coverage. You're trying to create some type of set pick to make the defender go over top, but he's open right there in the flat. Just got to put that ball 1 yard in front of his number and let Jarquez catch that ball and turn up field.
Caleb Downs is the man deep for Alabama. He stands at the Auburn 48-yard line to take this punt from Oscar Chapman. They come after him. Chapman gets it away, punts it away from Downs, who calls for a fair catch at the 49-yard line. And you hear the Auburn fan reaction to the non-face mask call that everybody in this ballpark saw except for the officials on the field. And Alabama, great field position now, leading 7-0 with 9:21 to go in the first quarter of play.
I just don't understand how that many refs missed that.
We'll send it upstairs. Paul Allen has a check of the Elwood scoreboard.
All right, Andy, a lot of the early games now wrapping up, and there were some interesting games in the early part of the wave today. And first, LSU pulled away in the fourth quarter. They beat Texas A&M 42-30. So LSU, ranked number 14, finishes the regular season at 9-3. Well, the ACC championship game kind of got messed up. Third win in a row for Kentucky in that intrastate rivalry as the Cats rallied late and beat Louisville 38-31. Kentucky now 7-5 to finish the season. Louisville drops to 10-2. And Michigan, with a late interception, staved off an Ohio State drive deep in Michigan territory. The Wolverines beat the Ohio State Buckeyes 30-24 in that big game between the number 3 and number 2 teams. So that's a Yellowwood update. Some interesting scores early. There will be others throughout the day in this rivalry weekend. Andy?
Let's pause 10 seconds for station identification. This is the Iron Bowl on the Auburn Sports Network from PlayFly. Thanks to everyone who registered online for the kickoff kit contest throughout the season at Jordan-Hare Stadium. Brought to you by Berkshire Hathaway Home Services. 7-0 Alabama leads, 9:21 to go in the first quarter of play. Boy, during this break, the Auburn head coach was wearing out the officials after the non-face mask penalty that everybody saw here at this ballpark on the replay on the video board.
Yeah, as he should be. Like, you saw it on the replay on the video board, and how many millions watching around the world saw it as well. And that flag came out immediately as his head turned.
Yep.
And we thought all that that was going to be called a face mask penalty. And for them to call a block in the back, I'm not sure what they were looking at. For one ref to miss it, I get it. But for two refs to sit in back and then one side ref right there watching that, I don't know how all three missed that.
All right, you got to overcome it now. First down for Alabama. Crimson Tide leads 7-0. Alabama with the ball at the Auburn 49 to start this drive. McClellan now in the pistol behind Milroe. They hand it to Milroe, or rather McClellan. He's taken down at the line of scrimmage by Keontae Scott, the junior out of San Diego.
Yeah, Auburn made an adjustment from that first series right there, bringing Keontae Scott from that star nickel position right there on a run blitz to tackle right there in the backfield. Huge play for Auburn defense.
Second down for the Crimson Tide. No gain on the play. Milroe in an empty backfield for the Crimson Tide. From the gun, right hash mark. Milroe, plenty of time. Flushed out of the pocket. Looks up the sideline. Gets pressured up the sideline, down the sideline, and out of bounds. He'll be shy of the first down. He goes out of bounds at the Auburn 42. Larry Nixon, the third, was the one that flushed him down the sideline. A 6-yard gain for Melrose, so 3rd and 4 for Alabama.
Yeah, Auburn defense, the backs right there did a great job of covering the receivers right there while Milroe stayed in the pocket so long. But we got to create pressure on Milroe. We cannot allow him to stand back there. As long as he's standing back there, you can't hold receivers for that long. We got to get pressure up front. Expect Auburn to bring some type of pressure, more than 4 rushers here.
McClellan flanks Milroe on 3rd down and 4 for the Crimson, actually third and a couple for the Crimson Tide. McClellan at the line, hit by Larry Nixon. He got a yard and that is all. Larry Nixon came up, the senior out of Fort Worth, forced McClellan back.
Yeah, Auburn got to hurry up and get back right now because I think this is territory for Alabama where they like to go for it, fourth and one right here. Defense got to stand up strong here, Andy.
Fourth and one, Alabama, 7 of 10 on fourth down this season. Roydell Williams is in at the tailback spot. He has the touchdown run today. It's a big, big play early on in this one. Fourth and one for Alabama. From inside the right hash, they try to get to the corner, they do. And down the sideline, it's gonna go Kendrick Law for a touchdown. And there are flags all over the place, and I think this one's going to come back, I think.
Yeah, Kendrick Law right there. There's a reason he sprung wide open right there for a touchdown, because you don't get a holding right there.
Holding, offense, number 81.
They got the tight end, C.J. Dupree, the junior from Scranton, Pennsylvania. A transfer from Maryland.
That's a big stop right there for this Auburn defense right there. Great field position for Alabama. And to be able to force a punt here, that was a win right there for this Auburn team.
Dupree with an obvious hole taking down Jalen Simpson. And now we'll see James Burnett averaging 47.9 yards a punt. Has 16 inside the 20 this season. And he is trying to pin Auburn deep. It is Keontae Scott for the Tigers at the 10-yard line.
Keontae Scott looking to the sun here. Make sure to secure the catch first.
Burnett gets it away. It's not a very good punt. Goes out of bounds, and Auburn's going to catch a break here. That one went off the side of his foot. Alabama is saying it was roughing the kicker. And they're going to mark it out of bounds at the 32-yard line. 7:14 to go in the first quarter. Auburn ball when we return. An 18-yard punt by James Burnett. First and 10, Auburn, trailing by a score of 7-0. This is the Auburn Sports Network from PlayFly.
Get your game day started with the Auburn Sports Network and the Tiger Tailgate Show, presented by Kaneka Sausage. Paul Ellen, Brad Law, Andy Burcham, Ronnie Brown, Will Herring, and Jason Campbell bring the tailgate party to you. Breakdowns of the games from every angle, visits from former Tiger greats, and updates from around campus 3 hours before kickoff of every Auburn game. It's the biggest tailgate party on the radio. The Tiger Tailgate Show, presented by Kaneka Sausage.
With Vizzy's vibrant dual flavors, the vibe is yours to decide.
I'm thinking Vizzy Refreshingly Berry. A round of blackberry lemon at the bar?
Could be good. Maybe Vizzy Vibrantly Tropical.
You always say Vibrantly Tropical.
Come on, a cooler full of papaya passion fruit on the beach?
Oh yeah, that's a vibe. I'm down.
Vizzy Hard Seltzer. Flavor for every vibe. Naturally flavored with other natural flavors. Celebrate responsibly. 2023 Molson Coors Beverage Company. Milwaukee, Wisconsin flavored beer.
Andy Burcham here to tell you about our friends over at Truckworks, the official commercial truck dealer of the Auburn Tigers. Truckworks is Alabama's exclusive Kenworth, Hino, and Isuzu commercial truck dealer, and the Southeast headquarters for dump trucks, sleeper trucks, box vans, and everything in between. Step into their TRP parts store in Opelika for all your commercial truck, trailer, and bus parts needs. Truckworks, the partner you can count on in the transportation industry since 1978.
We always picture the SEC student-athlete for their speed, their vertical, their agility. But it's time we picture them for more. For their campus voice, their community outreach, and for the simple fact that 20 years later, they're still someone's pride and joy. More than students, more than athletes. In the SEC, it just means more.
Seven minutes and 14 seconds to go in the first quarter. First and 10 for Auburn at its own 32-yard line. Best field position Auburn's had in this first quarter. Hand off Jarquez Hunter trying to get to the corner. Cuts it up. Jarquez across the 40. First down out to the 43-yard line. Best offensive play of the day for Auburn. Jalen Key A grad student from Quincy, Florida came up to make the stop. It's a gain of 11 for Jarquez Hunter.
Yeah, great block by Malcolm Johnson right there as well on the end, right there securing that edge for Jarquez.
First down for the Tigers at their own 43. The snap, the handoff, Jarquez right up the middle 50. He's to the 45, to the 40. Jarquez Hunter 30, down the Auburn sideline to the 20, inside the 15.
What a play right there again by Jarquez, hitting inside behind that right offensive line for a gain of 42, running behind Cam Stutz and Too Tall Miller right there as well. But another great block by Malcolm Johnson, springing Jarquez for another 15 yards on that run.
Auburn in the Chick-fil-A red zone, first and 10 for the Tigers at the 15-yard line of Alabama. Damari Alston is the Auburn tailback, flanking the quarterback, Peyton Thorne. Fairweather sets up outside the left tackle. From the right hash mark for Auburn. Handoff to Damari Alston. He's to the 10, inside the 10, and down near the 6. A 9-yard gain for Damari Alston off left tackle.
Yeah, Damari Alston right there running through Jalen Key right there. Auburn getting set quickly.
Second down and a yard for Auburn. Again, Alston tries to pick his way. He has, I think he does have the first down. It will be first and goal for Auburn at the 4.
Yeah, Auburn hitting between the tackles over there. Gunnar Britton and Dylan Wade on that left side right there the last two plays with Damari Alston, who's a physical running back himself, right here setting up first and goal for Auburn.
Four plays, 64 yards on this drive, and all on the ground for Auburn. First and goal for the Tigers at the Alabama 4-yard line.
They flank Fairweather to the right.
He is joined there by Malcolm Johnson, Jr. Now Fairweather will stay in the slot. Play clock is at 8. Thorne under center, turns, Damari Alston the carry, inside, spins to the goal line, he's in, touchdown Auburn!
What a run right there by Damari Alston again, running through Jalen Key, the safety for Alabama right there to spin around and to score a touchdown for Auburn. Great drive by the Auburn offense right there to respond, right there to rally this team back in this ball game. Great job, great movement, offensive line right there setting the line of scrimmage.
Second touchdown of the year for Damari Alston, the sophomore out of Woodward Academy in Atlanta.
A little bit of old school football there, Andy. You line up and go man on man.
And here is Alex McPherson out for the extra point. Jacob Quattabom will snap it. Oscar Chapman will hold it. And are they going to look at a review to see if he made it into the end zone or not? Every scoring plate is reviewed, so I think they're going to make sure that Alston made it in the end zone before he was down.
Yeah, that's tough running right there, too, by DeMar, those last two plays.
Yeah, it's a touchdown. So now the extra point for McPherson. 5 minutes to go in the first quarter of play. There's the snap. There's the kick. It's good. We're tied. Auburn 7, Alabama 7, 5 minutes to go in the second quarter, in the first quarter of play. Stay tuned, friends. Auburn football continues in a moment.
And we're back with the action. Coke Zero Sugar might be the best Coke ever.
That's right, Jim. With an irresistible taste and zero sugar, Coke Zero Sugar is a must-try for any sports fan. So make sure you... Wait, Jim, I didn't mean try it right now. We're still on the air.
Best Coke ever? Take a taste, Jen.
Really?
No, not right now, Jen. We got a game to call.
Sports not only bring us together, they inspire us on our own health journeys. Whether we're walking an extra lap, crushing a new goal, or spending time with friends cheering in the stands, we all win when we feel healthier and happier. That's why Blue Cross and Blue Shield of Alabama is a proud sponsor of athletic programs across the state. Because a healthier Alabama is a happier Alabama. Blue Cross and Blue Shield of Alabama. We cover what matters.
In football, it's important to call the right play. In life, it can be even more important to make the right call, especially regarding termite protection. To protect my home, I called Cook's Pest Control and got the Centricon system. You don't have to live with termites. For a free quote, make the right call. Cook's Pest Control and the Centricon system.
Looky, 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 here comes Cook.
Some people just know that the best rate for you is a rate based on you with Allstate. Not one based on the college football superfan who painted their back window in school colors and their side windows and the mirrors and most of the windshield. Why would you pay a rate based on anyone else? Get a rate based on you with DriveWise in the Allstate app.
Not available in California, subject to terms and conditions. Some states' participation in DriveWise allows Allstate to use your driving data for purposes of rating. While in some states, a rate could increase with high-risk driving, safer drivers will save with DriveWise. Allstate Fire and Casualty Insurance Company affiliates, Northbrook, Illinois.
Today's broadcast of the Iron Bowl is presented by Coke Zero Sugar. Irresistible taste, zero sugar. Now, back to Jordan-Hare Stadium for more of the Tigers and Crimson Tide.
Sun's out, John Deere Drive summary for Auburn. 68 yards in 5 plays, 2 minutes and 14 seconds, all on the ground. Capped up by the Damari Alston 4-yard run. Sun's out, John Deere, preferred track for the Tigers. Find your local dealer at sunsouth.com. Kool-Aid McKinstry, Kendrick Law and Roydell Williams to take this kickoff. And the kick is away from McPherson. And into the end zone. We'll send it downstairs. Cook's Pest Control sideline report with Will Harry.
Yeah, guys, I was telling Brad off the air, when the defense came off the field a while ago, there was an explosion of energy on the sideline. And our O-line just decided they were going to hit somebody in the mouth. Not a lot of trickery that last drive. We just ran the football and did it great.
Yeah, the two carriers were Jarquez Hunter and Damari Alston on every running play. And it's first and 10 for Alabama at its own 25-yard line.
Yeah, great downfield blocking as well on that last drive by Malcolm Johnson on the edge, springing Jarquez for that long run.
Auburn was offside apparently on the kickoff, so it's first and 10 for Alabama at its own 30. Roydell Williams is the tailback. Alabama scrimmages from the left hash at the 30. Milroe from the shotgun. Some movement up front. They get the ball to Milroe. He's in the pocket, rolls to his right, looks and he throws up the sideline. It's complete near the 47-yard line and a first down for Alabama to Isaiah Bond.
That play might need to get looked at again because they missed two holding calls and they missed the false start. But they also, the Alabama receiver that caught the ball, looked to step out of bounds before catching that ball.
First down for the Crimson Tide out to the 45-yard line. From the right hash. Milroe play action, throws to the boundary. It is complete. First down to the Auburn 40, down the sideline to the 36-yard line. Number 3, Jermaine Burton with the catch, taken out of bounds by Nehemiah Pritchett.
Yeah, Burton is their explosive receiver. They like to get him down the field and hit him with the big play, but he's also a guy that they throw the ball to underneath and try to get yards after the catch.
Boy, they're giving him some cushion out there on the perimeter too, aren't they?
Yeah, Nehemiah giving him maybe a little bit too much respect.
First down for Alabama into Auburn territory. As the Crimson Tide tries to respond to Auburn's tying touchdown. First down at the Auburn 36. Milroe to the line, now back. The play clock is down to 1. Barely gets the play off. Maybe he didn't. Nope, timeout Alabama. He was running out of time when he went to that line of scrimmage to change things. And Alabama uses his first timeout of the quarter. 3 minutes and 38 seconds remaining in the first quarter of play. Auburn and Alabama are tied at 7. By the way, Auburn's Chick-fil-A red zone touchdown means a free offer for everyone in the Chick-fil-A app. Download, log into your Chick-fil-A app to claim a free offer before midnight tonight. Redeemed by scanning or placing a mobile order next Monday through Friday at participating Chick-fil-A restaurants. Here's Paul Allen with a check of the Yellowwood scoreboard.
All right, a lot of rivalry games today. Territorial Cup is at the end of the first quarter out in Arizona, and Arizona leads at 10-7 over Arizona State, surprisingly close so far. BYU leads Oklahoma State in Stillwater. That could upset a few people. As far as the Big 12 championship's concerned, if BYU wins, the Big 12 championship will be between two SEC teams, Texas and Oklahoma. Vanderbilt at Tennessee was tied for a while. As they get near the end of the first quarter, Tennessee has scored on a 27-yard pass. The 21st-ranked Volunteers lead Vanderbilt 14-7. And Liberty bids to go 12-0. They lead at UTEP 21-7 at the end of the first quarter. Also out in Seattle, Washington State and Washington are tied, just getting underway in that one. That's a Yellowwood update. Andy?
The Apple Cup, it'll be interesting to see if that continues as Washington moves on and Washington State is left behind in the Pac-2. 3:38 to go, first quarter. Alabama ball, first and 10. At the Auburn 32 from the right hash mark. A pair of tailbacks flank the quarterback, Jalen Milroe. And he throws to one of those tailbacks who is taken out of bounds. Out of bounds at the 34-yard line, Kendrick Law, sophomore out of Shreveport. Austin Keyes, the man there for the Tigers.
Yeah, that's another RPO game they like to use with Milroe right there. Fake the ball to the running back, get him out on the edge. If a receiver's there, give it to him. If not, turn up field and get what you can get. Well defended right there for Auburn.
Second and 7 from the Auburn 33. Law in the slot. Handoff to the tailback. And taken down about a yard shy of the first down is Jam Miller. And a 5'10", 211-pound sophomore out of Tyler, Texas. His 30th carry of the season.
Well, good job by DJ James right there, forcing his third and one. Another tackle from the secondary right there. Alabama trying to set an edge, so these corners are going to have to come up and get dirty in this run game and hit some guys. Great job by DJ right there. Third and one.
Third and one for Alabama from the left hash mark. Hand off to the tailback, Jam Miller. He falls forward. He's got the first down just outside the Auburn 25-yard line. Austin Keyes was there for Auburn, but Miller got the yard he needed, and it's a first down for the Crimson Tide. Alabama now 2 of 3 on third down today.
Yeah, Alabama coming into this game, man, is 50% on third down conversion. That is a high completion conversion percentage for an offense.
Miller remains in the game, flanks Milroe from the left hash mark. First down from the Auburn 25. Play action, Milroe steps out of the pocket. He looks, he is a hit behind and he just floats it out of bounds. He didn't get that ball to the line of scrimmage. He was out of the tackle box, but did not get the ball back to the line of scrimmage, but no flag comes in. Now they're looking at it.
Quarterback was outside of the tackle box, and the ball went beyond the line of scrimmage extended. Therefore, it's an incomplete pass, second down.
Okay.
Yeah, that was really close right there of being intentional ground and a loss of down.
So second and 10 for the Crimson Tide. Good. Pass defense by the Tigers there. Handoff. McClellan inside the 20 off the right side. He gets to the 18-yard line before he's brought down. 7 yards on the game. Larry Nixon, the third, was there for Auburn.
Yeah, Larry Nixon making that tackle right there. Initial hit again from Nehemiah Pritchard, one of our secondary guys coming up, getting involved in the run game, putting a hit right there on McClellan first. And Larry Nixon finishing up. Big third down right here. See if we can force Alabama to a field goal.
Ball in between the hashes. Tailback goes in motion. Milroe drops the throw. All day to throw. Now flushed out of the pocket. He looks downfield. He's to the 15 and he goes down at the 12.
There's too much time, Andy, on these third downs. Milroe standing back there going through 1, 2, 3, and 4 progressions and then finding the opportunity to find a rush lane to run to. They're doing a good job of rushing to contain, but at some point you got to bring more than 4 to put pressure on him.
Alabama now 3 of 4 on third down in this first quarter. Final 41 seconds of the quarter. We're tied at 7, but Alabama drives to the Auburn 13-yard line. McClellan in the pistol behind Milroe from the left hash mark. Handoff to McClellan, bounces to the outside. He's to the 10 and run out of bounds inside the 10-yard line. Keontae Scott took McClellan out of bounds. Final 20 seconds now, the first quarter of play. Alabama doesn't have to run another play before this quarter ends. Zion Puckett actually was the one there for the Tigers to knock McClellan out of bounds, and it doesn't appear that Alabama will run another play before the end of the first quarter of play. Now the 88th Iron Bowl is one quarter deep. Auburn and Alabama are tied at 7. Alabama deep in Auburn territory, 2nd and 5 from the 8 when play resumes. Great things are possible when you have the power, performance, and smart features of a Ford F-150, the official truck of the Auburn Tigers. Greatness starts at your local Ford dealer. This is the Auburn Sports Network from Playfly.
Seasons Federal Credit Union is offering a 7-month CD at an annual percentage yield of 5.64% and a 13-month CD at an annual percentage yield of 5.38%. Four Seasons Federal Credit Union is the financial institution for you. This promotion is for new deposits only with a $2,500 minimum. Membership eligibility required. Accounts are federally insured by the National Credit Union Administration. Contact us for more details.
Fine Dining meets Southern Comfort at Vintage 2298, Auburn's newest fine dining restaurant and butcher shop. Chef Randall Baldwin and wife Laura present Gulf cuisine with a Southern flair made fresh farm to table. Seasonal meats, cheeses, wine, and handcrafted cocktails available next door at the butcher shop. Manager Stephen Jacobs and staff bring a new level of service to local dining at Vintage 2298. Private dining and event space available, as well as awesome tailgate packages found in the butcher shop. Experience Vintage 2298.
At Jewelry by Design, we design and hand make officially licensed Auburn University jewelry. We are fully stocked with the largest selection in town. Come by Jewelry by Design and see all of our fabulous designs. And just for looking, receive a free $60 Auburn charm. Just say, I heard you on the radio. Jewelry by Design, proudly making Auburn in Auburn. Find us at jbdauburn.com or 590 North Dean Road in Auburn.
1907. Auburn had no paved roads, no local newspaper, a few automobiles, very little electricity or indoor plumbing, and one bank, Auburn Bank. For all these years, we've had a part in shaping and serving Auburn, Opelika, and East Alabama, a steadfast partner to our customers, meeting financial needs at just the right times. How do we know our community so well? Because we've grown up together. Auburn Bank, champions of you. Member FDIC, online at auburnbank.com.
Well, Jalen Milroe lived up to his reputation. First six passes of the day. Auburn with a long drive all on the ground. After a quarter, we're all tied up in the 88th edition of the Iron Bowl. The game recap sponsored by Wind Creek Casino and Hotel with three Alabama locations in Atmore, Montgomery, and Wetumpka. You can escape every day at Wind Creek Casino and Hotel and WindCreekCasino.com. Alabama went 69 yards on their first possession. Jalen Milroe, the quarterback, the primary driver there, both passing and running. Roydell Williams scored the touchdown from 2 yards out. After an exchange of punts, though, Auburn came back down the field all on the ground. Big play, Jarquez Hunter, a 42-yard run, took him into the red zone. After that, Damari Alston took the ball into the end zone 2 plays later. 7-7 is our score as we go to the second quarter with Alabama threatening but trying to drive into the Auburn student section. We'll see what happens here with the call. Andy Burcham.
All right, Paul, thank you very much. During the quarter break, the 2013 Auburn Tigers were honored in the north end zone. Great to see a lot of those Tigers come back to campus after 10 years. My goodness, that's hard to believe.
No, time flies, I tell you.
All right, Alabama first down for the Crimson Tide in Auburn territory at the 8 from the left hash. Milroe around the left end, tries to get to the corner. Nothing doing. Taken down back at the 10-yard line.
Good
job. Zion Puckett along with Eugene Asante.
Great job by Zion Puckett right there, understanding his assignment, setting an edge right there against his Alabama offense, beating his guy to the point of attack right there, forcing Milroe to take a loss there.
Third down for the Crimson Tide. They can get a first down without a touchdown. 3rd and 7 from the left hash. McClellan flanks Milroe from the hash mark. Milroe with time now rows to the Auburn boundary. looking downfield. Milroe will run it to the end zone, touchdown.
He's got to be past the line of scrimmage.
Nyblack, the tight end with the catch. The sophomore from St. Petersburg, Florida.
Got a flag on the field.
And there is a flag down. Well, there were linemen downfield for the Crimson Tide.
Well, yeah, linemen downfield, but also I thought he passed the line of scrimmage. He'd be really close. Oh, his whole body passed the line of scrimmage.
Illegal four pass, offense number four. The penalty is 5 yards from the spot of the foul, the loss of down, fourth down.
And Will Record will be out to try and give Alabama the lead. That's a big play. Alabama has a touchdown. Now he's 2 yards beyond the line of scrimmage when he threw the football.
Yeah, I saw that immediately. I was like, his whole body's passing the line of scrimmage. You have to have some part of your body on the line of scrimmage for that to be a completion.
This is a 32-yard attempt for Will Reichard. He is 6 of 6 from this range this season, 16 of 18 overall on the year. Good snap, kick on the way by Reichard, and he splits the uprights, and Alabama regains the lead. And there is a flag on the play.
But offsides on Auburn right there on the edge. Jalen Simpson didn't get back quick enough. Alabama may decline because it's 4th and 11.
And that is the call. And now we'll get the official call.
Offside, defense, number 34. The penalty is declined. The field goal is good. Timeout.
So 14 minutes and 9 seconds remaining in the second quarter. Alabama on the board, but Auburn does not give up the touchdown. Alabama leads Auburn by a score of 10-7 in the 88th Iron Bowl. Stay tuned. Auburn football continues in a moment.
Hey, I'm Charles Barkley. Call for a Redmont and water at bars and restaurants throughout the great state of Alabama. Redmont Vodka, available at select ABC stores and package stores. Redmond Vodka is 8 times distilled, gluten-free, and is made from non-GMO corn. Looking to support a local business? Redmond Distilling is Alabama proud and minority-owned. Learn more online at redmonddistilling.com.
Yellowwood knows that a 5-star backyard is the place to make lasting memories, like cookouts, cornhole with friends. Ooh, a neighborhood potluck with your wife's pasta salad. The one with the feta. Oh, sorry. Or taking a nap on your deck in a hammock. Naps or memories? I love naps. For 5-star backyards and the most memorable experiences, Yellowwood brand pressure-treated pine. If it doesn't have that yellow tag, you don't want it.
The Houston Clinic would like to welcome Dr. Brad Young, the newest addition to our team of experienced medical professionals at Auburn's Houston Clinic. Specializing in joint replacements, sports medicine, and arthroscopic surgery, Dr. Young has treated athletes and worked with sports teams from middle and high school to college and professional teams. Call now to schedule your evaluation. Houston Clinic. Research, education, treatment. Houston.com.
Some people just know that the best rate for you is a rate based on you with Allstate. Not one based on the tailgater who's testing the laws of physics with a table and a grill and 6 camping chairs all balanced on the roof of a small sedan. Make that 4 camping chairs. Why would you pay a rate based on anyone else? Get a rate based on you with DriveWise and the Allstate app.
Not available in California, subject to terms and conditions. Some states' participation in DriveWise allows Allstate to use your driving data for purposes of rating. While in some states, a rate could increase with high-risk driving. Safer drivers will save with DriveWise. Allstate Fire and Casualty Insurance Company affiliates, Northbrook, Illinois.
Alabama went 56 yards in 12 plays, 5 minutes and 51 seconds. The Reichard, a 32-yard field goal. Gave the Crimson Tide a 10-7 lead with 14:09 to go in the second quarter. Auburn moving out of the south end zone. And it's Jarquez Hunter at the left hash mark and Brian Battee at the right hash mark to take this kickoff from Will Reichard. And Battee, who came 5 yards out of the end zone the last time, lets this one sail into the end zone, and Auburn will have 1st and 10 at its own 25-yard line. Well, Auburn's only scoring drive today was nothing. It was good field position one, and it was nothing but run against Alabama. What will the Tigers do here now, trailing 10-7 with 14:09 to go and moving from its own 25-yard line.
Yeah, those first two drives, we have to punt, got ourselves in bad situation being backed up behind the schedule in third and longs.
Hunter flanks. The Auburn quarterback to his left sends a man in motion. Hand off to Jarquez Hunter, trying to get to the corner, and he gets 2 yards on the play off the right side, taken down by Terrion Arnold, the redshirt sophomore from Tallahassee.
Yeah, great job right there by Jarquez of beating two edge defenders right there that was kind of turned loose on that play, just outrunning him to pick up a gain of 3 yards.
Second down for the Tigers. Second down, they'll call it 8, this time from the right hash mark. Auburn scrimmages from its own 27-yard line. Double wide receivers, wide side of the field. That's the Auburn boundary. They bring the blitz. Thorne runs away from it, looks, and he throws, and incomplete. Pass was intended for Kalen Burton III, but it was behind him and above him.
Yeah, that was a good check by Thorne initially right there, waving that over to Caleb Burton right there to run that speed out. Well, you want to run a sprint left pass, try to pick up a quick five and make it a third and short situation right there. That ball just kind of got away from Thorne. He got to turn his hips when you're going to your left and make an accurate pass.
It's been a tough start for Peyton Thorne. He's 0-4 in today's game, and this is third down and 8 for Auburn. The Tigers looking for their first third down conversion. They're 0-2. Alabama rushes 5. Thorne in the pocket, throws. It's complete. Caleb Burton. Caleb Burton across the 40 out to the 43. And that's an Auburn first down. 16 yards and a first down for the Tigers.
Yeah, good job right there by the offensive line as well, picking up Alabama's stunt right there, but also Caleb Burton getting the depth on his route right there, letting the initial receivers get out in front of him, causing the Alabama defender to get lost right there, which opened up Caleb Burton right there in the middle on an angle route for a first down.
First down for Auburn at the Tiger 42-yard line. Thorne initially under center. There's the snap. Play action, rolls to the Auburn boundary. He's going to run it. He's to the 45 and out of bounds at the 46.
Yeah, that was a design run all the way right there. Auburn offensive line pulled Dylan Wade right there, trying to get him upfield to get a block right there. I like that play design. May come back to it later on in a shorter down situation.
They give Thorne out to the 46-yard line, so second and 7 for Auburn. As Malcolm Johnson Jr. splits out to the Alabama boundary. And Javarius Johnson in the slot behind a couple of tight ends. Jarquez Hunter to the right of Thorne. Now Johnson goes in motion. Play clock is down to 4.
Take a timeout.
Auburn's going to have to take a timeout. Clock stopped with 12 minutes and 13 seconds remaining in the second quarter. Second and 7 for Auburn at its own 46 when play resumes. Alabama 10, Auburn 7. Stay tuned. This is the Auburn Sports Network from Playfly.
Things we take for granted, ordinary opportunities for parents and their children, can be a foster child's extraordinary. You have the power to do something positive that will change the life of a young person right here in Alabama. Open your heart and open your home to a foster child today. For more information, visit www.dhr.alabama.gov or call 1-866-4AL-KIDS. Brought to you by the Alabama Department of Human Resources, the Alabama Broadcasters Association, and this station.
Here's a clip from a recent Talking Tigers podcast with Andy Burcham.
Joe Witt Jr.
Funny story, when we won the Orange Bowl in 2006 with Coach Petrino, and at that time, Coach Chizik was at Iowa State, and then Coach Petrino had an opportunity to go to the Falcons. And so I was going to Iowa State, and my dad told me, because Bobby was like, well, you go talk to your dad, and if you still want to go to Iowa State, you're good, because he was going to bring me to the Atlanta Falcons with him. And my dad said, Joe, you need to get that recruiting tag off your name. Because nobody was giving me credit for being a good coach. I was just known as a recruiter. And so he said, if you want to do right by you and your family, you go to the NFL.
A new episode of the Talking Tigers podcast is released every Monday. Wherever you listen to podcasts, like and subscribe to the Talking Tigers podcast, only from the Auburn Sports Network.
With Vizzy's vibrant dual flavors, the vibe is yours to decide.
I'm thinking Vizzy Refreshingly Berry. A round of blackberry lemon at the bar?
Could be good. Maybe Vizzy Vibrantly Tropical.
You always say vibrantly tropical.
Come on, a cooler full of papaya passion fruit on the beach?
Oh yeah, that's a vibe. I'm down.
Vizzy Hard Seltzer. Flavor for every vibe. Naturally flavored with other natural flavors. Celebrate responsibly. 2023 Molson Coors Beverage Company. Milwaukee, Wisconsin flavored beer.
Back to the Iron Bowl at Jordan-Hare Stadium. Alabama 10, Auburn 7, 12:13 to go in the second quarter. CBNS Bank has been family, community, and financially strong since they began in 1906. Visit cbsbank.com. Member FDIC, equal housing lender. Second and 7 for Auburn at its own 46 from the left hash mark. Fromm goes in motion. Thorne turns, hands the ball. Jarquez Hunter stood up at the line of scrimmage, is able to shed one at tackle, and gets maybe a yard on the play, and that's about all. Yep. Justin Aboikbe with the stop for Alabama.
Yeah, tough running right there. Jarquez inside on that inside zone, creating a third and four situation here for Auburn. Valdo Fairweather as well back in the game. Haven't seen him a whole lot today, battling that shoulder injury from a week ago.
33 catches, tying an Auburn school record for tight ends. John Samuel Schenker. There's third down, I'll call it six for Auburn. Empty backfield for Thorne, trips to the Auburn boundary. Now Jarquez comes in motion Auburn way. Thorne turns, throws, complete. Jarquez Henner forward, looks like he has the first down. Auburn needed six, he may have six and a quarter, but that's an Auburn first down into Alabama territory at the Crimson Tide 48.
Yeah, good route right there by Javaris Johnson running that inside slant. The motion kind of confused Alabama a little bit. Jarquez motioning away, taking that linebacker out of that vacant area in the middle of the field, creating Javaris Johnson to beat his guy on the inside slant.
Inside 11 minutes to go in the second quarter, Alabama 10, Auburn 7. First down for the Tigers at the Alabama 48. Jarquez Hunter with the carry. Hunter makes a nice cut, gets inside the 45, near the 41-yard line, before he's brought down by Deontay Lawson, sophomore out of Mobile, with 52 tackles coming into play today.
Yeah,
good carry by Jarquez.
Yeah, great job right there by Jarquez and Peyton Thorne, because the defender initially was right there at Jarquez but didn't know who had the football.
Second and four for Auburn. Alabama line shifts to its left. Thorne from the gun. Thorne to Jarquez, jets forward. Jarquez still on his feet near the Auburn first down. Stays on his feet, gets, boy, that's just a hard run by Jarquez and that Auburn offensive line. First down Auburn.
That offensive line right now, they want Auburn to run the football. Gunnar Britton, Dylan Wade, Tutal Miller, Jeremiah Wright in there right now. Avery Jones back in the starting lineup today at the center position. Dylan, they feel good about running the ball against this defensive front.
Damari Alston replaces Jarquez Hunter in the game. First and 10 for Auburn at the Alabama 37. Ball at the right hash mark. Thorne, the handoff to Damari Alston, and he is immediately brought down on the play. Big tackle by Dallas Turner, junior out of Fort Lauderdale. That is the league-leading 11th and a half tackle for loss for Alabama this season.
Yeah, Dallas Turner, the midseason All-American right there. Got to know where he's at all times on the football field. That time we wasn't able to beat him to the edge, tackling Auburn right there for a loss. But this is a big second down for this Auburn offense. You got to create a third and shorter situation.
It's second and 16 for Auburn. Ball back to the Alabama 43. Micah Riley goes in motion, sets up outside the right tackle. Now Damari Alston in motion out of the backfield. Thorne in some traffic. Down he goes near midfield. Dallas Turner was there, but so was Justin Aboikbe, a redshirt senior from Forest Park, Georgia.
Yeah, Justin Aboikbe right there had an effect on that one, beating our guys up front. Pocket collapsed really quickly on Thorne right there.
That is the sixth sack of the season for Aboikbe. And now third and 21 for Auburn. They marked him down at the Alabama 48. Play clock at 9, ball between the hashes. Hand off to Jarquez Hunter, and Hunter close to the 46-yard line before he's taken down. Some pushing and shoving After the play.
Excuse me, man. I think what Auburn was trying to do right there is trying to catch Alabama in a drop zone defense and pass coverage and try to sneak Jarquez in there in a little inside run, see if he can pick up 10 or 12 and give McPherson an opportunity for a long field goal. But unfortunately, have to punt the ball here in this situation.
Caleb Downs drops to retrieve this punt by Oscar Chapman. Steps to his right and kicks it away. Downs lets it bounce, and it's downed at the one-yard line by Jalen Simpson. Inside the one, as a matter of fact.
Yeah, great job right there. Jalen Simpson getting downfield right there, but even a better job by Oscar Chapman allowing his guys on the outside to get down the field so he can punt that ball so they can be there for the catch.
47-yard punt by Chapman inside the one. 7:36 to go in the second quarter. Alabama 10, Auburn 7, Crimson Tide ball inside the Crimson Tide 1 when play resumes. Stay tuned, friends. Auburn football continues in a moment.
It takes hard work to be the best in the game. Planning, commitment, resilience, sweat. That's why Old Dominion Freight Line, the number one national LTL carrier for quality, works hard to be the best in the game and is proud to support those striving to be the best in theirs. Old Dominion Freight Line, official freight carrier of Auburn Athletics, helping the world keep promises.
By now, your daily routine is probably a little too routine. Don't you want to change? Don't you want to start playing by your own rules and escape the routine so your fantasy becomes reality? Where every night is an adventure, where new flavors are ready to be tasted, where it feels like you're a winner. Take a chance. Reward yourself. Make your routine anything but routine. Escape every day at Wind Creek Casino and WindCreekCasino.com.
When you live in SEC country, you feel it everywhere you go. The traditions and rivalries surround you. As much as you celebrate the game, Regions celebrates your financial wins even more. And like SEC fans, we'll never quit. Because in an SEC world, we're the SEC Bank. Regions, official bank of the SEC, member FDIC.
Kaneka Sausage is a fan favorite for tailgating, always great on the grill, and it's the official sausage dog and hot dog of the Auburn Tigers. Kaneka Sausage is made from the finest cuts of pork, their patented blend of seasonings, and smoked over a pure hickory fire for that true southern flavor. Be sure to visit the Kaneka gift shop in Evergreen, Alabama, right off I-65 at exit 96. Enjoy a crowd-pleasing Kaneka Sausage dog while watching the Tigers and make Kaneka part of your game day. Kaneka Sausage, since 1947, a real winner.
This broadcast of the Auburn-Alabama game is presented by Coca-Cola. They say Coke Zero Sugar is irresistibly tasty. Does that make it the best Coke ever? Find out for yourself. Now, back to more of the Iron Bowl from Jordan-Hare Stadium.
Heavy set for Alabama, just trying to get off the goal line with Jalen Milroe running, and he gets about a yard.
Yeah, in this situation, you want to get all your big guys up front right there. Don't give Alabama an inch down here. Don't let them get in a situation where they feel more room and space. But, Andy, this is a situation, an opportunity for Auburn to make Milroe uncomfortable. He hasn't been uncomfortable yet in this ball game. He's been able to stand back there with no pressure so far.
Second and 9 from the 2 for Alabama. Milroe out of the gun. McClellan flanks him. Handoff to McClellan, bounces to the outside, and then stood up at the 4-yard line by Jalen Simpson.
Yeah, we talked about it early in this ball game. Our secondary coming up making big hits in the run game. Going to have to do that against this Alabama football team that likes to be balanced. But this is an opportunity right here for this defense to stand up and create a short field for your offense.
Alabama is 3 of 5 on third down in this first half. This will be 3rd and 6 from the Alabama 5. McClellan is the tailback. Milroe, the quarterback, stands a yard into the end zone. Trips, bunched to the right of the set. And now the tight end Nyblock goes in motion. Milroe, 2-throw to the boundary. Wide open. Nyblock has it. Taken down at the 10. Shy of the first down. Is that Jalen McLeod that made the stop for Auburn at the 10-yard line?
Yeah, great job by Jalen McLeod and Jalen Simpson right there coming up.
And McLeod is slow to get up. He's on a knee right now at the 10-yard line. Auburn brought pressure from the edge. The pass was complete to Nyblack. And just a great job by Simpson. And he's shy of the first down. Or did they give him a first down?
No, he should be shy right there. That's not a first down. He didn't even make it to the line of scrimmage right there. I would challenge this.
5 minutes, 48 seconds.
They have given him a first down.
No way. I would challenge this if I'm Hugh Freeze. He's a half a yard short here. The throw behind him right there created Jalen Simpson time to get to him and rally and make the tackle there.
And now they're going to look. It's a review to look at the spot of the play.
Yeah, he never made it to that line.
He didn't even close.
The ruling on a first down is under video review. Timeout.
Replay reviews are brought to you by Auburn's Houston Clinic. Don't let a sports injury bench you this season. Go to Houston for your fracture, sprain, or strain, because orthopedics is all they do. Go straight to the specialist. Go to Auburn's Houston Clinic. By the way, and the good news about all this, Jalen McLeod, who was on a knee for a while, was able to run off the field under his own power.
Yeah, Auburn did a good job right there. Jalen McLeod running from the defensive end position upfield, but then they brought Cam Rowley on a round blitz right there, forcing Milroe to throw that ball to the flat, which forced an errant throw, which gave Jalen Simpson an opportunity to rally and Jalen to come and make the tackle.
The review continues on the spot. The spot on the field is a first down for Alabama.
Yeah, it'd be good for Auburn to get some of these calls. You know, some of them that refs have missed today going against us.
Yeah, and here comes the call from Jason Autry.
The ruling on the field stands. Oh, the runner made the 11-yard line.
Boy, oh boy. I'll just bite my tongue.
There again.
Because he was a half yard shy of the first down.
Another call going against Auburn right there. He's half a yard short right there for a first down. And for them to say first down, I'm not sure what they're looking at.
All right, first down for Alabama on a play that he didn't make. He just didn't make it. The replay shows it. I'm not sure what they're looking at on the replay right now, friends. First down for Alabama from its own 11. You've got to just overcome the call. Milroe with McClellan behind him, or to his side. Handoff goes to McClellan. Head down across the 15-yard line out to the 17. Getting up off the bottom of the pile for Auburn, Keontae Scott. They give him to the 11-yard line. Excuse me, to the 16. Second and 5, Milroe. Gets some pressure. Milroe gets away. Elijah McAllister was held. Milroe down the sideline. Goes out of bounds at the 25-yard line.
That's the thing about Miro. You gotta stay on this guy. Right there, Elijah McAllister had an opportunity for a huge sack and a loss, which would have created a huge third down for this Alabama offense. Backed up. Oh, we got to hang on right there.
Yeah. Out to the 25. First down for Alabama. Prentice in motion. Handoff up the middle. Larry Nixon brings down the tailback out to the 31-yard line.
Yeah, Andy, the game is won between the lines out there, but we're not getting a lot of help on some missed calls today that are just obvious. But you got to win the game regardless. Yeah. You got to continue to play and play through it.
McClellan with the carry, second and 5 for the Crimson Tide to the 30. Roydell Williams now the tailback, flanking Milroe. Brings Benson in motion to the Auburn boundary. Ball up between the hashes. The snap to Milroe. With some time. Looks and he throws across the middle. It is caught at the 49. Nope, incomplete. Intended for Isaiah Bond.
Again, that's just too much time for Milroe back there. We got to get him in these situations where he's having to deliver the ball without waiting for his third option to come open right there down the field. You can't hold these guys forever if you're a secondary. We've got to find a way to create pressure up front, whether we do some blitzing or we bring more than 4, but we've got to do something to put him in situations that he's uncomfortable with.
Alabama is 4 of 6 on third down. This is third and five. The clock stopped with 3:46 to go in the second quarter. Alabama leads 10-7. Milroe throws to the Alabama boundary, almost picked off. Nehemiah Pritchett got up to break up that pass.
Man.
Pass intended for Bond, and Pritchett knocked it out of the air.
Boy, a hair a second later, that would have been Pritchett running that ball to the end zone, hitting his head on a goalpost for a touchdown for Auburn. That's a hairy throw by Milroe to throw that ball from the opposite hash to try to throw that ball right there. Good breakup by Nehemiah Pritchett. If that happens again, it may be pick six for Auburn.
Keontae Scott back to take this punt from James Burnett. Keontae at the Auburn 24-yard line. The snap to Burnett, and he gets the punt away. Another short punt by Burnett, and a flag is down. It comes to Keontae. Auburn's going to get called for a block in the back, and an unnecessary block in the back.
Yeah, right there, Keontae did a good job of feeling that, make sure that ball doesn't roll any further.
And, boy, easy to make this call.
During the kick, illegal block in the back. Return team number five.
Yeah.
10-yard penalty from the end of the kick. It'll be first down, Auburn. Timeout.
3:32 to go in the second quarter. Alabama leads Auburn 10-7. First down for the Tigers when we return. This is the Auburn Sports Network from Playfly.
Live Sports Radio, bringing you inside Neville Arena for all the action of men's and women's basketball game day with no delay. Every dunk, block shot, and steal, plus all the analysis from our Hall of Fame coaches, all with no delay. $25 new or $10 to reprogram the one you already have. Also, use it for every broadcast of home baseball and softball games this spring, all with no delay. With Live Sports Radio, presented by Alpha Insurance.
What does commitment sound like? At Alabama Power, we hear you, we see you, and celebrate you on long practice days, game days that bring us together, and every day in between. Your commitment to making an impact for the team, for the fans, that inspires us to be at our best for the communities we champion across the state. We're committed to this kind of energy. That's power for a better Alabama. Alabama Power is a proud supporter of the Auburn Tigers.
Hey, it's Amanda, and a little thing I love about the Chick-fil-A nugget trays is that they're so easy for the holidays. They're warm and flavorful. It's always a crowd pleaser. When I put down a nugget tray, everyone is happy.
Hey, this is Brian, and the little thing I love about the Chick-fil-A nugget trays is the joy that it brings to me and everybody around me during the holidays. They're warm, juicy, and delicious.
Cater the holidays with Chick-fil-A today. Available on the Chick-fil-A app. Real guests paid for their testimonials.
Sports not only bring us together, they inspire us on our own health journeys. Whether we're walking an extra lap, crushing a new goal, or spending time with friends cheering in the stands. We all win when we feel healthier and happier. That's why Blue Cross and Blue Shield of Alabama is a proud sponsor of athletic programs across the state. Because a healthier Alabama is a happier Alabama. Blue Cross and Blue Shield of Alabama. We cover what matters.
After the block and the back penalty against Auburn, the Tigers will open first and 10 at their own 12 with 3:32 to go in the second quarter. Alabama on top by a score of 10-7.
Yeah, important drive right here for this Auburn offense.
Thorne from the gun. Deal in motion, now sets up outside the right tackle. Auburn hands it. It is Damari Alston to the 15 up the sideline, close to the first down. Near the 21-yard line, Kool-Aid McKinstry with the stop for Alabama. Nice run by Damari Alston.
Yeah, great job right there by Dylan Wade and Luke Deal setting the edge right there for Damari.
A gain of 8 on the play, second and 2, 3:14 and counting. In the second quarter, second down and 2 for Auburn. Alston remains in the game at tailback for the Tigers from the left hash mark. He flanks Thorne to his right. And in motion, they hand the ball to Damari Austin. Damari Austin, 25-30. He's to the 35, to the 40, to the 50 with a man to beat. Down the sideline, and he is out of bounds to the 20 with a flag down. This is going to be a face mask against Alabama.
Great job right there by that offensive line on that left side right there. Damari hit it inside between the tackles for a gain of 60 yards. Great play right there by Auburn. And tack on the 15 yards as well in the face mask.
And Auburn is in the Chick-fil-A red zone.
Personal foul, face mask, defense number 6. First down, Auburn.
Jalen Key called for the face mask on what turned out to be a touchdown-saving tackle after the run by Damari Austin of 56 yards.
Yeah, that was important. Andy Norton, Alabama had 2 timeouts and could receive the ball. If we didn't pick up a first down there with a chance to score before the half and to receive the ball after the first half. Big drive right here for this Auburn offense.
Burton comes out. Javaris Johnson is in for the Tigers. First and 10 for Auburn at the Alabama 12. Thorne under center. Austin is the tailback. Thorne turns. Hands the ball. It's the reverse. Javaris Johnson, 10. He's to the 5. He dives. He's in. Touchdown, Auburn. Touchdown, Javaris Johnson. 12 yards.
Great job by that offensive line again and the receiving corps setting the edge behind those big tight ends over there as well. The screen that reversed for a touchdown. Javaris Johnson utilizing his speed to get to the edge and to dive in that end zone. Great drive by the Auburn offense. Take this lead right here going up.
2:24 to go in the second quarter, and Auburn has his first lead of the 88th edition of the Iron Bowl. Extra point from Alex McPherson. Kick is on the way. It's good. It's good. 2 minutes and 24 seconds to go. Second quarter of play as the Auburn Tigers have taken the first lead of the game. 14-10 Auburn. Downstairs, Will Herring has a Cook's Pest Control sideline report.
Fellas, these boys are beginning to believe that they belong. There's been no trickery. It's downhill football. We're running the football. We're hitting them in the mouth, offensively, defensively. I mean, guys, this has been a team effort. There's not a lot of razzle-dazzle. We know we don't have the deep threats at the wide receiver position. It is what it is right now, so it's smash-mouth football. And these guys are bringing the energy back to the sidelines. Offense, defense, these big guys up front are setting the tone.
It's an Alabama defense that has been holding opponents to just under 118 yards rushing this season. Auburn has 159 yards rushing in the first half. Jarquez Hunter, 6 carries, 74 yards. Damari Austin, 6 carries for 73 yards. Sun South, John Deere drive summary for Auburn, 88 yards, 3 plays. A minute 8, Javaris Johnson on the reverse, the touchdown run of 12 yards. Sun South, John Deere, preferred tractor of the Tigers. Find your local dealer at sunsouth.com.
Yeah, what I was going to say there, Andy, is the fact that us running the football really well, it neutralizes Dallas Turner and Chris Braswell in the passing game where they can't get those sacks and put pressure on Peyton Thorne. So that's what the good run game is doing, is allowing our offensive line to take shape in this game.
Kendrick Law, Roy Dell Williams to take this kickoff from McPherson. And it will be Williams. And he sit at the 19-yard line and driven to the turf. Kendrick Law. I think that was Jarquez Hunter that spearheaded that.
They got Larry Nixon right there, Andy, running down the field, and Jarquez. You're exactly right. The running back involved again on kickoff coverage. We've talked about it all year. These guys are turning up the temperature right now against Alabama.
All right, checked. It's first and 10 for Alabama. It will start at its own 19. Reminder, Alabama 2:17 to go in the half and 2 timeouts remaining. This place is it's electric right now, friends.
Yeah, it's Iron Bowl time right now, Andy. Yeah. And the best thing right this situation is Auburn defense got to have a big stand knowing that Alabama receives the ball after the half.
Jace McClellan flanks Jalen Milroe. Brings Nye Black in motion, handoff to McClellan, and McClellan finds his way forward out to the 23-yard line. Keys was there for the Tigers. So was Justin Rogers. Alabama back to the line after a 4-yard gain. Second and 6. at the Auburn 23, under 2 minutes to go in the second quarter. Milroe to throw. With time, throws it across the middle to McClellan. He's got it, and a first down out to the 32-yard line.
Yeah, Auburn trying to play the bend, but don't break defense right here. But you got to be careful, though, letting Alabama hit those underneath, because the clock stops on them automatic first downs under 2 minutes.
It's rolling now with a minute 44 and counting. First down from the Alabama 32. Low snap to Milroe. Looks up the seam, down the seam, and he's got a man wide open. It's Jermaine Burton who scores a touchdown. Blown coverage by Auburn. 68 yards and a touchdown for Alabama.
Yeah, DJ James right there got caught looking in the backfield instead of staying on his guy Burton down the sideline. We talked about it pregame. His best big play threat is Burton. But DJ James got to understand, you got to drop back in coverage right there. And don't worry about what's underneath you. Just don't get beat deep in this situation.
So Alabama answers in quickly. A minute 33 to go in the half. And Reichert out to try and make it a three-point Alabama lead. Out of the hold of James Burnett. And the kick is up and it is good by Reichert. He's 49 of 49 this season. 1:33 to go in the second quarter, and Alabama regains the lead 17-14. Alabama has scored after each of Auburn's touchdowns today. And the Crimson Tide leads with a minute 33 to go in the second quarter. Auburn University isn't just home to the best athletics program in the nation. It's also home to the best student-centered engineering experience in America. That's not just a slogan, it's a promise. Find your future at the Samuel Ginn College of Engineering. Visit eng.auburn.edu. 81 yards in three plays, 44 seconds. Burton from Milroe, 68 yards for the score. The Crimson Tide goes back on top, 17-14. Jarquez Hunter and Batiste are deep for Auburn to take this kickoff from Reichert. Whew, that didn't take long, did it?
Yeah, Auburn got to respond. Now you got time with two timeouts left.
Reichert kicks it near Batiste, who takes it at the goal line. Out to the 10, 15. Batiste gets across the 20 and he's driven down at the 21-yard line. Let's pause 10 seconds for station identification. This is the Iron Bowl on the Auburn Sports Network from PlayFlow. .128 to go in the second quarter. Alabama 17, Auburn 14. Auburn first and 10 from its own 21. Jarquez Hunter, the tailback for the Tigers. Flanks Peyton Thorne to his right. Thorne on the day, 2 of 6, just 20 yards. From the right hash mark. Brings a man in motion. Thorne off the right side. Jarquez Hunter tries to bounce to the outside. He's ridden to the turf at the 28-yard line by Terry and Arnold.
Yeah, Auburn can go fast now because they picked up so many yards on first down. Now you can go fast and not to worry about Alabama using their timeouts.
Second down for the Tigers. At the 27, Thorne wants to throw. Sets up, throws it down the middle. In and out of the hands of Rivaldo Fairweather. The pass was a bit low to Fairweather, but he couldn't pull it in. And he had him open. Doggone it.
Yeah, Thorne got to put a little bit more on that ball. But right there, Fairweather can also reach down to catch that ball. I just wonder how much of that shoulder affected him bending down, catching this ball right here. Man, that's a missed opportunity for a big play there. Mm.
Third and 4 with a minute 4 to go in the second quarter. Auburn 2 of 5 on third down today. The Tigers need 4 yards to keep this drive alive. They bring the house. Thorne in trouble and he goes down back at the 24. Deontay Lawson's the one that tripped him up. Yeah, third sack of the year for Deontay Lawson. Man, oh man, you cannot come up empty on a pass that is that wide open down the middle of the field. And Alabama calls a timeout with 55 seconds to go in the second quarter.
Yeah, you got to catch that ball. I know it wasn't a perfect pass, but at the end of the day,
it's got to be a better pass and you got to catch it.
Yeah, you got to catch that ball right there. That would have set Auburn up at the 50-yard line, still with two timeouts remaining to get in the field goal range. That's just a missed opportunity right there.
And then on third down and 4, Alabama brought everybody. and got to Thorne, and Lawson came up with his second, make that third sack of the season.
Yeah, you have to expect, Andy, at halftime that Alabama's going to take a look at all the plays that have been run against them in the run game, and they're going to try to pressure us in the run game and force us to throw the ball here in the second half a little bit. So we got to make the plays when they are there right there to be made.
Alabama 17, Auburn 14, 59 seconds to go in the second quarter. Alabama does have a timeout remaining, as Auburn will punt this one away. Chapman back at the 9 to punt it. Ball will be snapped from the 24. Alabama does not come after Chapman, who booms it away. Caleb Downs. Nicely played back at the 25-yard line. Caleb Downs taken down on the play.
Well, Champ Anthony right there running down the field, making a big hit.
And it just didn't let loose. didn't let loose at Downs.
Yeah, great job of hanging on right there, because Alabama had their cover set because the punt was a really good punt by Oscar. But good job by Champ Anthony right there holding on. That may be a play that may not many people not think about, but that was a huge right there.
Second 50-yard plus punt by Chapman today. That was a 51-yarder. Alabama first and 10 at its own 25, 50 seconds remaining in the second quarter. Alabama with a timeout remaining. Trips to the wide side of the field. Single receiver to the Alabama boundary. From the left hash mark, Milrone, an empty set. Auburn rushes 4. Milrone in the pocket. Now flushed out of the pocket. Milrone to the Auburn boundary, and he throws it away. Good coverage by the Tigers. And pressure up front by Austin Keys and Keldrick Falk.
All right, that was great pressure right there by Auburn, because the best thing they did was Milrone let 9 seconds run off the clock. That's what you want to do right there as a defense.
Milrone on the day, 10 of 14, 176 yards and a touchdown. Second and 10 for Alabama. Clock stop with 41 seconds to go at its own 25. Crimson Tide lead Auburn 17-14. From the left hash, double wide receivers right and left. Tailback flanks Milrone. Tailback with the carry out to the 24-yard line. Excuse me, the 29-yard line is Roydell Williams. Austin Keys on the stop, and Alabama uses his final timeout to stop the clock with 33 seconds to go in the second quarter. And it will be 3rd and 5 for Alabama at its 30 when play resumes.
Yeah, if I'm Auburn, if we stop them here, I would use a timeout. If it's incomplete, you don't have to use a timeout. But if they do some type of run and we stop them, I will use one of my timeouts, see if we can get a good punt return, take a couple of shots to get in field goal range.
Alabama's been good on third. Alabama's been good on third down this season, 50% coming into today, and is 4 of 7 on third down today.
And Andy, a lot of that is because they hardly ever get behind schedule. What I mean by that, they don't get in the lose those yardage situation on first downs and second downs where they're behind the sticks. They do a good job of staying in those short third and short situations. And you see Milrone, he gets close to the sideline. Instead of taking a loss, he just throws it out of bounds.
Well, I'm going to check that right now. Burton and Prentice split to the Auburn boundary, the wide side of the field. 3rd down and 5 for Alabama at its own 30. Isaiah Bond comes in motion to the Auburn boundary. Milrone drops the throw, steps up into the pocket. He is flushed. Milrone up the sideline and out of bounds, shy of the first down. He's 2.5 yards shy of the first down. Good pass coverage by Auburn, and a nice job to contain Jalen Milrone. And he stopped going out of bounds. He stops the clock with 23 seconds. Auburn doesn't have to burn a timeout yet. And now Alabama will punt it away.
Yeah, you hit it right on the head there, Andy. He stepped out of bounds. That saved Auburn a timeout right there, which we have 2 timeouts. Depending on what Keontae Scott does with this punt return right here, we'll see if Auburn decides to take a couple of shots to see if we can give McPherson the opportunity to hit a long field goal here before the half.
Do you go after him here?
Punter? I would go after him, see if you can force an errant punt, because you don't want to let him get off a good punt here.
And a flag is down. A flag thrown in the Auburn backfield.
Good delay of game.
Delay of game against Alabama.
Game. Kicking team, 5-yard penalty, remains 4th down.
All right, that's five more yards back for Alabama.
Yeah, I like to see Auburn go after this punt here. If I'm Keontae Scott, I kind of move up a little bit.
Burn it to punt it away. Keontae now up to the Auburn 35-yard line to take this. Auburn is coming after it. Doesn't get that close. Burnett kicks it away. Keontae Scott calls for a fair catch at the 30. 17 seconds and two timeouts remain for Auburn at its own 30 after a 42-yard punt by Burnett.
Yeah, and in this situation right here, Auburn has two timeouts. You're trying to pick up at least, I would probably say, 35, 40 yards here. They have an attempt at a long field goal.
Well, you get to the 40, and I think you've got a shot, the Alabama 40. I think you've got a shot at a long field goal attempt by McPherson. Just 17 seconds to go in the half.
Yeah, this first down play is going to be the most important play.
Thorne out of the empty gun. Trips to the wide side of the field, the Alabama boundary. Thorne from the shotgun on first down from the 30. It's a quarterback draw. Thorne, 35-40. And taken down at the 48-yard line. Auburn quickly back to the line of scrimmage. Clock stops 11 seconds, an 18-yard gain and a timeout.
A great play call right there, catching Alabama in a drop zone where they're rushing three, dropping eight guys right there. Good job of calling the quarterback draw, picking up at least 20 yards right there on that play, on that run right there by Peyton Thorne.
Out to the 49. I think you're about 11 yards out of the area. I mean, if you get to the Alabama 40, it's about a 57-yard field goal attempt by McPherson. He once told me that he has made, in practice, a 73-yarder.
Wow. Well, I say this, the best thing right now, we have that one timeout, allows you to utilize the entire field. That's the best part. So now you can throw the ball in the middle of the field and still use your timeout.
Total offense in the first half, Alabama 272. 176 through the air, 96 on the ground. 201 yards total offense for Auburn. 20 yards in passing and 181 yards in rushing against an Alabama defense that has been holding opponents to about a buck 17 a game.
I keep my eye right here on Javaris Johnson down here in the slot and Fairweather just in case.
They're split to the Auburn boundary on first and 10 from the Auburn 49. The snap to Thorne in an empty set. Get rid of it, Peyton. And he does as he throws it out of bounds over the head of Fairweather with 6 seconds to go.
Yeah, smart play right there, Peyton, and not taking that sack, forcing us to use a timeout, which would probably end the half based off the situation. But right here, though, you can run a 10 to 12-yard hook. If you're the inside receiver, just find that 35-yard line right there and just settle in between the zone coverage of Alabama.
Got 6 seconds. Thorne from the gun, drops the throw, steps up into the pocket. He looks and he throws over the head of Fairweather, and he had him open. And that'll be the final play of the second quarter. Boy, twice he's had Rivaldo Fairweather open across the middle. He underthrew him one time and overthrew him there.
Yeah, it's been some miscommunication between
them. Game clock to 1 second.
And they're going to give one more second. Oh, 1 second. 1 second at the end of the half.
Ah, run it. But right there, you just talked about it, though, Andy. Those two got to get on the same page. The first time, you know, Fairweather could have caught the ball, but a little bit lower to throw, but still catchable. That situation right there, he overthrows Fairweather. You got to get on the same page. Those missed opportunities right there, you got to have them.
Fairweather and Shane Hooks, along with Jay Fair, split to the Auburn boundary. Thorne looks to throw. He's in traffic. He throws it downfield. Near the goal line, and it's caught. It's an interception at the goal line by Terry and Arnold, and that's the way the first half comes to a close. So the first half is over, and Auburn trailing Alabama by a score of 17 to 14. Let's go down. Now we await getting Will Herring with the Auburn head coach. Will hold for just a moment. And of course, Paul Allen with the halftime show, Connect the Sausage halftime show. Truckworks, excuse me. Will Herring down there to get the thoughts of the Auburn head coach. Tigers trail 17 to 14. Going into the locker room at the half, Auburn came in a solid 2-touchdown underdog. Coming into this Iron Bowl, Auburn briefly led in this one, but Alabama quickly responded with that 3-play, 81-yard drive.
Yeah, Andy, right there, there's plays to be made. Right.
And now we'll go down to Will Herring, who's standing by with head coach Hugh Freeze.
Coach Freeze, you guys have established the running game in the first half, rushing for about 180. Obviously, you gave up the deep ball then. Talk to me about the first half.
Yeah, that's really proud of the effort, proud of our fight, proud of the way we're running the ball. But, you know, we drop a pass there. It was kind of iffy throw. We got to make that. But we can't blow a coverage when we go up 14-10. You know, we need that momentum going into the half. And, dang, if we just totally blew a coverage.
Good luck in the second half.
All right, well, thank you very much. Our score at the half, Alabama 17, Auburn 14. Now, Paul Ellen with the Truckworks Halftime Report.
All right, thank you, Andy. Let's take a look at the top 25 scoreboard on the Yellowwood scoreboard to start things off. As expected, halftime out in Arizona, the Territorial Cup, and number 15, Arizona, pulling away from Arizona State 38-7. Jed Fish, is he tempted to leave his alma mater? We'll see, but right now, Arizona blowing out Arizona State. Meanwhile, BYU throwing the Big 12 championship game next week into all sorts of fits. BYU leading Oklahoma State in Stillwater 24-6. Oklahoma State ranked number 20, by the way. They would like to be in that game. If they're not, it'll be an all-SEC championship for the Big 12 championship. Tennessee and Vandy, a closer than expected game. 1:05 to go in the first half. Volunteers lead it 24-10 as they play in Knoxville. Liberty bidding for an undefeated regular season. They lead 28-7 over Texas El Paso out in El Paso. They will host the Conference USA Championship game next week. Apple Cup, 7:13 to go in the first half. And Washington State and fourth-ranked Washington all tied up at 7 apiece. Washington with the ball and driving. But right now, the Washington State defense is giving all sorts of fits to the Washington Huskies as they play there. A couple of other games earlier that finished. Number 3, Michigan, a late interception held off number 2, Ohio State, 30-24 in that Big Ten battle. And Kentucky got a late touchdown and a late interception. They beat number 10, Louisville, in Louisville, 38-31. That takes a little luster off the ACC championship. This is the Truckworks Halftime Report, offering Kenworth, Hino, and Isuzu commercial trucks, allowing Truckworks to provide the solution for virtually any commercial trucking need. Stay with us. We'll have your first half story with highlights and statistics when we come back. This is the Auburn Sports Network from Playfly.
When Auburn football hits the half, keep it locked on the Auburn Sports Network for the Truckworks Halftime Report. Paul Ellen takes the driver's seat and delivers stats, scores, highlights, and analysis from the first 30 minutes. Plus, an on-field interview with head coach Hugh Freeze, getting you ready for the rest of the game. The Truckworks Halftime Report on the Auburn Sports Network.
Hey Auburn fans, it's Coach Hugh Freeze. Care teams at Ascension St. Vincent's care for the whole person. They know healthy lifestyles help prevent chronic illnesses, and cultivating a healthy lifestyle starts early. That's why we're partnering with them to sack obesity. For every Auburn sack, a donation is made to the Ascension St. Vincent Foundation to purchase PE equipment for schools around the state. Join Jill and me by making a donation to sack childhood obesity. Visit stvhsfoundation.org, War Eagle.
At Oslo USA, we're building ships that protect and defend our nation. Building innovative ships requires innovative people. We're looking for Tiger fans to join the build. We offer 4 10-hour day work schedules for our production employees, comprehensive benefits, and individualized training programs that make our dynamic workforce even stronger. Visit OsloJobs.com to apply today and build a strong future. Oslo USA, innovative on land, exceptional at sea.
When you see the SEC student athlete, it's easy to picture the swing, the stance, the form. But look closer, and you'll see the heart, the brain, the clutch lab partner, the avid two-stepper, the pride of a hometown, and a little brother's hero. More than students, more than athletes. In the SEC, it just means more.
Alabama leading Auburn 17-0.
This is the Truck Works Halftime Report. Visit truckworks.com to learn more about the company or to learn about career opportunities with Truck Works. Back to Paul Ellen.
Alabama leads Auburn 17-14 at halftime. Time for the story of the first half is called by Andy Burcham. Auburn won the toss, took the ball, but couldn't move it. After they punted it away, Alabama from their 31 wasted no time moving downfield, eventually getting to a first and goal at the Auburn 2-yard line.
No score, but Alabama is knocking at the door. Williams again into the end zone for a touchdown for the Crimson Tide.
Roydell Williams.
Yeah, that drive just looked too easy for Alabama right there. You get them in a third and long situation where you want this team to be at, behind the schedule and behind the sticks. You cannot allow Milroe to sit back there on third and long like that and let these explosive receivers that they have get that open in the middle of the field right there, convert that third down, which have now turned out to be a touchdown for Alabama.
Milroe went 4-for-4 on the drive, 8 plays, 69 yards for Alabama, 7-0. Then an exchange of punts, Auburn getting the ball at the 32-yard line. The Tigers wasted no time showing they were going to the power game, and for at least a few minutes, it was going to work.
First down for the Tigers at their own 43. The snap. The handoff, Jarquez right up the middle, 50. He's to the 45, to the 40. Jarquez 130, down the Auburn sideline to the 20, inside the 15.
What a play right there again.
Ball marked at the 15-yard line. Hunter went to the bench. Damari Alston checked in, and 2 plays later, he paid off the drive.
Play clock is at 8. Thorne under center. Turns. Damari Alston the carry. Inside, spins to the goal line. He's in! Touchdown, Auburn!
What a run right there by the...
5 minutes to go in the first quarter, and that tied it up. The 68-yard drive in 5 plays made it 7-7 into the first quarter. Alabama answered with a field goal drive to make it 10-7. Auburn came right back and moved the ball for 3 first downs, but a tackle for loss and sack ended that drive. Alabama had to punt the ball away, and that set Auburn up deep in their own territory at the 12-yard line. But it didn't take long for the Auburn running game to get untracked.
Alston remains in the game at tailback for the Tigers from the left hash mark. He flanks Thorne to his right. And in motion, they hand the ball to Damari Alston. Damari Alston, 25-30. He's to the 35, to the 40, to the 50 with a man to beat. Down the sideline, and he is out of bounds to the 20 with a flag down. This is going to be a face mask against Alabama.
Run covered 56 yards with the face mask. It set Auburn up at the 12-yard line, and it only took Auburn about 5 seconds to capitalize.
Thorne turns. Hands the ball, it's the reverse. Javarius Johnson, 10, he's to the 5, he dives, he's in! Touchdown, Auburn! Touchdown, Javarius Johnson!
14-10, Auburn led, 2:24 to go in the half, but Alabama with a very quick answer as their quarterback, Jalen Milroe, found a man behind the Auburn defense.
It's rolling now with a minute 44 and counting. First down from the Alabama 32, low snap to Milroe. Looks up the seam, down the seam, and he's got a man wide open. It's Jermaine Burton who scores a touchdown. Blown.
Burton went 68 yards with the pass, an 81-yard drive in just 3 plays. Alabama took that 17-14 lead with a minute and a half to go in the half, and that's the way the half ended. 17-14 Alabama, big plays from both sides. When we come back, we'll look at your halftime statistics. That's when the Truck Works Halftime Report continues in a moment.
Andy Burcham here to tell you about our friends over at Truckworks, the official commercial truck dealer of the Auburn Tigers. Truckworks is Alabama's exclusive Kenworth, Hino, and Isuzu commercial truck dealer, and the Southeast headquarters for dump trucks, sleeper trucks, box vans, and everything in between. Step into their TRP parts store in Opelika for all your commercial truck, trailer, and bus parts needs. Truckworks, the partner you can count on in the transportation industry since 1978.
Recruiting plays a major role in team building. Recruiting also plays an important role in protecting my home from termites with Cook's Pest Control and the Centricon system. Termites eat the bait in the Centricon stations, then eagerly recruit other termites to also feed on the bait, thus eliminating the termite colony. You don't have to live with termites. Call Cook's Pest Control for a free quote.
Looky, looky, looky. Here comes Cookie, Cook's Pest Control.
Yellowwood knows that a five-star backyard is the place to make lasting memories, like roasting marshmallows on a cool fall night. That's it. Turn it nice and slow. Get it toasted all... Oh, no, it's on fire. Oh, you want it on fire. Okay, that's a choice, I guess. Crunchy. For five-star backyards and the most memorable experiences, Yellowwood brand pressure-treated pine. If it doesn't have that yellow tag, you don't want it.
And we're back with the action. Coke Zero Sugar might be the best Coke ever?
That's right, Jim. With an irresistible taste and zero sugar, Coke Zero Sugar is a must-try for... Aw, Jim!
Best Coke ever? Take a taste, Jen.
We're still on the air.
Hello, this is Coach Hugh Freeze. They say Coke Zero Sugar is irresistibly tasty. Does that make it the best Coke ever? Find out for yourself. War Eagle.
This copyrighted broadcast is authorized under rights granted to Play Fly Sports by Auburn University and is intended solely for the entertainment of our audience. It may not be rebroadcast or retransmitted in any form without the documented consent of Auburn University and Play Fly Sports.
Alabama with a field goal lead at halftime, 17-14. Time for a look at your halftime statistics presented by the Alabama Department of Public Health, who remind you, don't wait, vaccinate. Protect yourself and others by staying current on all recommended vaccines, including COVID and flu. Visit alabamapublichealth.gov/IMM. It's as you would expect. Alabama moved the ball well through the air. Auburn moved it pretty well on the ground, and it's a tight game. First downs, Alabama with 13, Auburn with 10 in the first half. Crimson Tide ran for 96 yards but passed for 176. They snapped it 36 times for 272 yards. Auburn ran the ball 22 times for 181 yards. They passed it for 20. 32 snaps for Auburn, 201 yards. The punting game was big for both teams. Alabama punted three times for a 20-yard average. That can't be right. Auburn four punts for a 47-yard average, and the Tigers able to gain and keep field position for a while with that. Penalties, five for Alabama, 47 yards, five against Auburn for 28 yards. Third down conversions, Alabama holding for their season regular season record. They were 50%. They were 4 out of 8. Auburn was 2 out of 7 on third down. Individually, Jace McClellan ran the ball 10 times for 50 net yards for Alabama. Easy to figure, that's a 5-yard net. Jalen Milroe, 7 carries for 23 yards. For Auburn, Jarquez Hunter ran the ball 10 times for 80 yards. For Auburn, Damari Alston, 6 carries for 73 yards as Auburn broke a number of big running plays. Jalen Milroe, 10 for 14, throwing the ball. He hit his first 6, 176 yards and a touchdown. Peyton Thorne, just 2 for 10 with an interception. That came on a Hail Mary at the last play of the game. And Peyton Thorne was sacked 2 times in the first half. Jermaine Burton, a big first half, 4 catches, 107 yards, and a touchdown. Kendrick Law, 2 catches for 8 yards for Alabama. Caleb Burton had 2 catches for 15 yards for Auburn. Leading tacklers in the game, Jalen Key for Alabama, 4 tackles. Austin Keys and Jalen McLeod both had 4 tackles for the Auburn Tigers. It has gone back and forth in the first half of this game as Alabama jumped out early, led 7-0, dominating the game as Auburn 3-and-out on both of their first 2 possessions. But then Alabama had to punt the ball away late in the first quarter. Auburn put together a big 68-yard drive all on the ground to tie things up at the end of the first quarter. Alabama answered with a field goal drive to open the second quarter. Auburn came back, though, with a big drive highlighted by a Damari Alston, a 56-yard run, and took the lead at 14-10. Alabama came right back on a bomb from Jalen Milroe to Jermaine Burton. 17-14 is where we stand at halftime. Alabama leading, and Alabama will have the ball coming out in the second half. That'll do it for your Truck Works Halftime Report for the Iron Bowl, the 88th edition. Stay with us when we come back. Andy Burcham will have the second half story. This is the Auburn Sports Network from Playfly.
We've all fallen into boring routines. We just keep doing what has to get done. Isn't it time to escape the old routine and make time for yourself? Make time to go out with old friends. Make time to add excitement back into your life. Make time to feel like a winner again. Life is more fun when you live it. So what are you waiting for? Escape every day at Wind Creek Casino and WindCreekCasino.com.
And we're back with the action. Coke Zero Sugar might be the best Coke ever.
That's right, Jim. With an irresistible taste and zero sugar, Coke Zero Sugar is a must-try for any sports fan. So make sure you... Wait, Jim, I didn't mean try it right now. We're still on the air.
Best Coke ever? Take a taste, Jen.
Really?
No, not right now, Jen. We got a game to call.
Kia of Auburn is happy to connect the Kia brand to the Auburn fans. Our winning lineup has something for everyone at almost any budget. SUVs like the Telluride, Sorento, and Sportage. You prefer a sedan? Check out the Rio, Forte, Soul, or the Sporty Stinger. And don't forget our new multi-purpose vehicles, the Carnival, or our amazing hybrid or electric vehicles. Kia of Auburn is a proud supporter of Auburn Athletics. Kia of Auburn, where you're always number one. Whoa, Rico.
Tackle your to-do list this season and find the right Aetna Medicare plan for you in your home state of Alabama. With Aetna Medicare Advantage plans, you can get a $0 monthly plan premium with hospital, medical, and prescription drug coverage. Plans also include dental, vision, and an over-the-counter benefit. Be the star quarterback of your health. Call us for a personalized coverage review now. 1-833-771-7542. TTY-711. Aetna Medicare is an HMO PPO plan with a Medicare contract. RSNPs also have contracts with state Medicaid programs. Enrollment in our plans depends on contract renewal. Plan features and availability may vary by service area.
Halftime at Jordan-Hare Stadium. Tigers trail Alabama by a score of 17-14, along with Jason Campbell, Will Herring, Paul Ellen, Gene Dulaney, Brad Law, Patrick Tisdale, Ben Harling. I'm Andy Burcham. Jason Campbell in our booth. We've got Will Herring on the sideline. Well, let's start with you, Will. What do you expect defensively in this second half of play? Alabama was able to use its passing game very well, or to its advantage, in the first half of play.
Yeah, you know, Jalen Milroe several times was able to get outside the pocket and extend the plays and make plays with his arm just by extending the play. So we've got to continue to rush and do our best to keep him contained. Offensively and defensively, I love just the energy and the belief. These guys are not scared of those boys wearing the crimson helmets across the field. And as long as our boys are believing and playing with the confidence, especially on the offensive line, I love what I'm seeing. Now, we know Alabama's a great coach team. They're going to make some adjustments. We're going to have to pull the ball with our quarterback. We're going to have to run it with him. We're going to have to throw it with him. We're not going to be able to just continue to feed our running backs. But you got to be overall, you got to be pleased with our running game in the first half.
Will, what did you see on the coverage breakdown right there that allowed Burton to get that touchdown on a go route down the sideline? Was it supposed to be 3-deep zone or man coverage?
I was talking to one of the guys on the sidelines. It sounds like they called a corner blitz, and the corner was unsure about the car and got caught in like no man's land. And it's like if you either blitz or you get deep, but if you get caught in no man's land, you're screwed. So there was obviously a breakdown. I don't know if it would have been a corner blitz. That means Puckett should have been rolling over the top. So I'm not sure who it falls on, but it's very disheartening when you have the lead going into the half with a minute and something, and you give up a deep ball like that.
All right, this Crimson Tide defense is better in the second half than the first. They've given up just 80 points in the second half of games this season. 41 in the third quarter, 41 in the fourth. Teams are averaging just 7.3 points in the second half against Alabama this season. What does Auburn have to do offensively, Jason?
Yeah, offensively, I think you continue to run the football like you've done. But the next thing is you're going to get those linebackers coming up trying to attack and trying to stop Jarquez and Damari Austin from running the football like they did in the first half. So that's going to open up lanes in the middle of the field for Fairweather, for Caleb Burton and Javaris Johnson, those guys. So look to try to take advantage of that as an offense. But I like the pace that we're on.
Take it to the house with the Alabama Manufactured Housing Association and the Auburn Tigers. This week's Take It to the House contestant is Pam Williams of Coffeyville. If Auburn returns his first received kickoff of the second half for a touchdown, Pam wins up to $75,000 towards the purchase of a manufactured home from an authorized AMHA dealer. If the Tigers score a touchdown within the first three plays of the drive, Pam wins $25,000. Alabama will take the opening kickoff of the second half and defend the north goal. So Alabama will be coming out of the Auburn student section in the fourth quarter. Law and Roydell Williams are deep, and McPherson puts a foot into it, and there will be no return as it sails into the end zone. So first and 10 for Alabama at its own 25-yard line. What does Auburn have to do to get some pressure in the second half on Jalen Milroe?
Well, ending that first half, we allowed Jalen Milroe to sit back there and kind of be comfortable in the pocket and not have to force anything. In the second half, I think we go into the halftime, we make some adjustments, we come out, and we got to find a way to rush more than three or four on third down to make him put him in a position to turn the ball over and create a short field for offense.
Isaiah Bond, Jermaine Burton split to the wide side of the field. That's the Auburn boundary. As Alabama scrimmages from the left hash mark, Jace McClellan flanks Milroe on first down. Play action by Milroe. Steps into the pocket, he throws, and it's caught for a first down by the tight end Amari Nyblack. Out to the 43-yard line, Zion Puckett in coverage.
Now, Zion Puckett was in great coverage. Just a great throw, excuse me, by Milroe and Nyblack.
First down out to the 43-yard line for the Crimson Tide. Bond splits to the Alabama boundary. That's the short side of the field. Handoff to McClellan. He's to the 45. Head forward across the 50 and near 10 yards. Looks like he's going to be about a half yard shy of the first down. Excuse me, they gave him the first down. Eugene Asante knocked him out of bounds.
Yeah, Eugene Asante right there running sideline, making that tackle. But Auburn's on this drive, Andy. This is important that Auburn doesn't allow Alabama to get into a rhythm and get points here to start this third quarter.
First down for Alabama in Auburn territory at the 47. Ball at the left hash. Robbie Utz, the tight end. It's the pitch. Tailback trying to get to the outside. He does, and he's run out of bounds at the 41. That's Kendrick Law to the wide side of the field. An Auburn player is down. That is Keldrick Falk. Falk had the first shot at Law in the backfield. But Law outran him to the Auburn boundary. He was knocked out of bounds at the 41-yard line.
Kendrick Falk, our star signee this past offseason from Highland Home, Alabama, has had to step up in a big way since losing Messiah Kite.
Now Messiah Nasili Kite out for the season with that torn bicep. And Keldrick Falk has stepped in as an Auburn true freshman. Timeout on the field will give you an update on Keldrick when we come back. Alabama second and 5 at the Auburn 42. 13:50 to go in the third quarter. Alabama on top of Auburn 17-14 as Auburn football continues in a moment.
La-fa-fa-fa-fa-fa-fa-fa.
Don't you mean fa-la-la-la-la-la-la-la?
Nope, we're shaking things up.
Whatever you say.
Shake things up this season at the Toyota-thon sales event. Lease a new 2024 Toyota RAV4 LE for $339 a month for 24 months, plus $500 holiday bonus cash. Toyota, let's go places. Offer valid through December 5th, 2023. Well-qualified lessees with approved credit through Southeast Toyota Finance. 3638 due at signing. No security deposit with select equipment. $350 disposition fee. Excludes tax, tag, registration, title, and dealer fees. See dealer for details.
What does commitment sound like? At Alabama Power, we hear you, we see you, and celebrate you on long practice days, game days that bring us together, and every day in between. Your commitment to making an impact for the team, for the fans, that inspires us to be at our best for the communities we champion across the state. We're committed to this kind of energy. That's power for a better Alabama. Alabama Power is a proud supporter of the Auburn Tigers.
Jim Gaffigan here with some more straight talk. Let's take a moment to appreciate our sweet children, loving grandparents, and eternal soulmates. Now let's use them to save money on wireless. Because with the Straight Talk Silver plan, you get 4 lines for just $25 a month with unlimited data and no contracts. So add those human pawns, I mean loved ones, and save money. Thanks, kids. It's finally worth it. Straight Talk Wireless, available at Walmart.
Get 4 lines on Silver Unlimited for $25 per line per month, plus taxes and fees. For data management practices and additional terms, visit straighttalk.com.
Shop Cyber Gold and Gable deals at Lowe's. Get up to 45% off and save an extra $100 on every $800 you spend on select major appliances. And you can buy now and pay later with Lowe's Pay for instant financing for online purchases. Because Lowe's knows deals. Valid through 11/26 while supplies last. Savings vary based on purchase amount. Exclusions apply. See Lowe's.com for details. Lowe's pay installment loans are subject to credit approval and provided by Synchrony Bank. Available online only.
Keldrick Falk walked off the field under his own power. He is on the sideline being tended to by the Auburn medical staff. So Zacchaeus Walker, the junior from Ellaville, Georgia, at that defensive end spot. As Alabama scrimmages second and five from the Auburn 41 at the right hash mark. A pair of tight ends in the game. Oots in motion sets up outside the other tight end. Hand off to McClellan. Bounces to the outside and he's run down from behind. Zero, Keontae Scott. Just ran down at Jace McClellan. And it's third and five. Make that third and four for Alabama.
Great tackle by Keontae Scott. The second time in this ball game, he's come from that nickel star position to make a tackle in the backfield for a loss against this Alabama rushing game.
Justin Rogers out, Marcus Harris in up front for the Tigers. Alabama was 4 of 8 on third down in the first half. This is third and four from the Auburn 40. McClellan goes in motion out of the backfield. It's a run by the quarterback. He's got the first down and out of bounds at the Auburn 27-yard line. Milroe just flushed out of the pocket, went forward easily enough for the first down for Alabama.
Yeah, Auburn tried to bring secondary pressure on that play right there to create Milroe into a situation to create a turnover, bringing Jalen Simpson off the edge, but he's able to step up in the pocket right there and scramble.
To the Auburn 26, first down for the Crimson Tide from the right hash mark. Oots and Dupree set up outside the left tackle. Milroe looks that way. Now throws it wide open across the middle, inside the 20, down to the 16-yard line is Isaiah Bond.
Yeah, high percentage pass and throw right there for Jalen Milroe to throw that crossing route. Auburn rallying and tackling.
Falk back into the ball game, replacing Walker in the defensive end spot for Auburn. And Roydell Williams now the tailback for the Crimson Tide. Second and one from the Auburn 17. Williams again, he got hit behind the line of scrimmage by Marcus Harris. Harris was the first one there, Elijah McAllister helped. And it's gonna bring up, it's about a loss on the play, and it's third and two.
Harris did a great job of splitting both the left guard and the left tackle on that play to create that loss, to create this third and three situation for this Auburn defense.
From the 18, they'll call it third and two for Alabama from the left hash. Roydell Williams is the tailback, flanking Milroe. Now Williams moves to Milroe's right. Alabama scrimmages from the left hash. It's a pitch to Roydell Williams. He's got the first down, head down inside the Auburn 10 to the 8. Boy, he put the head down and drove Cam Riley back. And it's a first down. That's a good hard run by the senior out of Hueytown, Alabama, Roydell Williams. First and goal for Alabama at the Auburn 8-yard line.
Yeah, that was a great play call to call that play. Tossing bunch formation. Out flanking Auburn right there on the edge.
Jermaine Burton to the Auburn boundary. Isaiah Bond to the Alabama boundary. Milroe, Williams, right up the middle to the 5 and down to the 4 before he's driven back by the Auburn defenders. Getting up at the bottom of the pile, Lawrence Johnson for Auburn and Marcus Harris.
Alabama trying to get behind that big offensive line, trying to wear down this Auburn defensive front, which is very thin with some of the injuries we've had so far this year.
Second and goal from the 4, double wide receivers left to the Alabama boundary, including Isaiah Bond and Cole Adams, with Jermaine Burton wide right. Milroe rolls to his right. He gets taken down at the line of scrimmage. Falk came from behind to take down the quarterback. And it'll be third and goal from the 4.
Good to see catcher Falk back in the game. Adding that depth to this defensive line. Losing him would have been a huge loss for this defense. Creating a third down situation.
All right. Going into the Auburn students right here. As both Jalen McLeod and Marcus Harris are in. And it's McClellan back at tailback on third and goal from the 5 for Alabama at the right hash. Bond comes in motion. Milroe from the right hash looks that way. looks to the end zone. He throws. It's incomplete. Intended for Bond. Defensive pressure from DJ James.
That's great defense by DJ James. Because Milroe had time in the pocket, but you playing man coverage in this situation, backed up. Great job for this Auburn defense to put Alabama into a field goal situation.
Will Reichert is 17 of 19 this season. And this will be a short one of 23 yards. The holder is James Burnett. Neyland Hibbett is the snapper for Alabama from the left hash mark. Snap down, the kick on the way by Reichert. And the kick is good. Well, Alabama drove to the Auburn 4, but that's where the drive stalled. And with 9:12 to go in the third quarter, Alabama adds to its lead. Crimson Tide 20, Auburn 14. Auburn to get the ball for the first time in the third quarter when we return. This is the Auburn Sports Network from Playfly.
War Eagle, it's a great day for Auburn Tigers to get vaccinated. Many children and adults that delayed vaccinations during the pandemic are still behind schedule. It's crucial that we take steps to get everyone back on track with their routine immunizations. Children and teens can still catch up on their vaccinations even if they start late. Make sure you and your family are all up to date on all recommended vaccines, including COVID-19 and flu. Let's all do our part to get back on track. Don't wait. Vaccinate. For more information, visit alabamapublichealth.gov/IMM.
The 50-yard line at Jordan-Hare.
Play action. Reed in trouble. Reed gets rid of it. And it's picked off. James at the 20, to the 15, to the 10. Down the sideline. He's gone. Touchdown, DJ James.
Center court at Neville Arena.
Auburn. SEC champs, start to finish. The Tigers win 82-71, and the celebration begins at Auburn's Neville Arena.
Behind the plate at Plainsman Park.
The 2-2, swing and a miss. He struck him out, and the Tigers win. In 2018, they celebrated in Raleigh, North Carolina. In 2019, in Atlanta. But today, Auburn celebrates at Plainsman Park.
We put you right in the middle of the action. This is the Auburn Sports Network from Playfly.
La fa 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 fa.
Don't you mean fa la 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 la?
Nope, we're shaking things up.
Whatever you say.
Shake things up this season at the Toyotathon sales event. Lease a new 2024 Toyota RAV4 LE for $339 a month for 24 months, plus $500 holiday bonus cash. Toyota, let's go places. Offer valid through December 5th, 2023. Well-qualified lessees with approved credit through Southeast Toyota Finance. 3638 due at signing. No security deposit with select equipment. $350 disposition fee. Excludes tax, tag, registration, title, and dealer fees. See dealer for details.
Alabama went 71 yards on its first drive in the third quarter, 12 plays, 5 minutes, 48 seconds, 22-yard field goal by Will Reichert gives the Crimson Tide a 6-point lead with 9:12 to go in the third quarter. Auburn about to get its hands on the football for the first time in the third quarter. Jarquez Hunter, Brian Petit at the goal line taking this kickoff from Reichert. And there will be no return as Petit watches it go 6 yards into the end zone. Auburn's got to be better through the air in the second half, Jason. Just 2 of 10 for 20 yards in the first half.
You're right, Andy. The opportunity will be right there for this football team. In the middle of the field is where I like everything, because the simple fact we've been running the ball good in between the tackles and the guards. Expect this Alabama linebacker core to creep up a little bit, which will open up opportunities at the second level.
10 carries for 80 yards for Jarquez Hunter in the first half. He flanks Peyton Thorne on first and 10 from the 25. Auburn sends a man in motion. It is Thorne up the middle, and Thorne gets maybe a yard, and that is all. Deontay Lawson was there. They'll give him two. A Boykbe with the stop as well for Alabama.
Auburn may want to come back to that play again, because if he hand that ball off to Jarquez, the edge was sealed very well. He may be still running.
Put it in your back pocket. Second and 8 for Auburn. Ball between the hashes. Thorne from the gun. Alabama puts 4 on the line of scrimmage. Jarquez Hunter to the outside. Jarquez 30 and run out of bounds at the 31. Stop made by Terry and Arnold for Alabama. It's going to bring up third actually third and three. They gave him to the 32-yard line, 6 yards on the carry. So third and three, Auburn in the first half, 2 of 7 on third down.
See if Auburn goes with the RPO game here with Luke Deal and Rivaldo Fairweather to the boundary.
Malcolm Johnson, Javarius Johnson to the Auburn boundary. Bring Javarius in motion. Thorne drops 2 steps to throw. Looks and he throws. Complete. Javarius Johnson, 45-50. Alabama territory down the Alabama sideline. Makes a move. Down to the 31.
Good protection. Good throw by Thorne. Javarius Johnson in the slot. Ran an option route where you can break out or break in. Great job of making the decision to break in versus man coverage for a gain of 37 yards for the Auburn offense.
To the Alabama 31.
Robbie Ashford now checks in the game.
Ashford, the Auburn quarterback. First down from the Alabama 31-yard line. From the right hash mark. Handoff. Nope, it's Robbie Ashford. And Ashford inside the 30. They're going to mark him down. He thought he was still moving forward as he dove to the 20, but they will mark him down at the 28-yard line.
Yeah, they'll say his left knee hit the ground before he got up and took off again.
Ashford remains in the game. Second and 7 as the clock moves down to the 7-minute mark in the third quarter. Auburn trails 20-14. And now Thorne into the ball game for the Tigers at quarterback. Play clock is down to 8. Auburn's going to have to hustle. Down to 4. Thorne from the gun. Down to 1. And Auburn either calls out. Auburn has to burn a timeout.
Yeah, that's tough to have to use a timeout early in third quarter, but you can't allow to lose yardage.
Agreed. Stops the clock with 6:42 remaining in the third quarter. Second and 7 for Auburn at the Alabama 28. Alabama 20, Auburn 14. Right back with you. Stay tuned. Auburn football continues in a moment.
What does commitment sound like? At Alabama Power, we hear you, we see you, and celebrate you on long practice days, game days that bring us together, and every day in between. Your commitment to making an impact for the team, for the fans, that inspires us to be at our best for the communities we champion across the state. We're committed to this kind of energy. That's power for a better Alabama. Alabama Power is a proud supporter of the Auburn Tigers.
With Vizzy's vibrant dual flavors, the vibe is yours to decide.
I'm thinking Vizzy Refreshingly Berry. A round of blackberry lemon at the bar?
Could be good. Maybe Vizzy Vibrantly Tropical.
You always say Vibrantly Tropical.
Come on, a cooler full of papaya passion fruit on the beach?
Oh yeah, that's a vibe. I'm down.
Vizzy Hard Seltzer. Flavor for every vibe. Naturally flavored with other natural flavors. Celebrate responsibly. 2023 Molson Coors Beverage Company. Milwaukee, Wisconsin flavored beer.
Boot Barn's Black Friday weekend sale is happening right now, where you can save on top quality pieces. Get up to $40 off select cowboy boots for men and women, $20 off select work boots, and select children's boots for under $50. Visit us today during our biggest sale of the year, with Black Friday savings extended throughout the weekend for easy holiday shopping. Boot Barn. Unwrap the West.
Tackle your to-do list this season and find the right Aetna Medicare plan for you in your home state of Alabama. With Aetna Medicare Advantage plans, you can get a $0 monthly plan premium with hospital, medical, and prescription drug coverage. Plans also include dental, vision, and an over-the-counter benefit. Be the star quarterback of your health. Call us for a personalized coverage review now. 1-833-771-7542. TTY-711. Aetna Medicare is an HMO PPO plan with a Medicare contract. RSNPs also have contracts with state Medicaid programs. Enrollment in our plans depends on contract renewal. Plan features and availability may vary by service area.
Today's broadcast of the Iron Bowl is presented by Coke Zero Sugar. Irresistible taste, zero sugar. Now back to Jordan-Hare Stadium for more of the Tigers and Crimson Tide.
Second and 7 for Auburn at the Alabama 28. Thorne back at quarterback for Auburn from the right hash mark. Jarquez Hunter to his right. Javarius Johnson comes in motion. Thorne pulls it, now throws it. He's got Johnson wide open. 10-5, touchdown Auburn! Touchdown Javarius Johnson!
Great play call right there by Coach Montgomery. Coach freeze, seeing Javaris Johnson in man coverage, faking that ball to Jarquez inside, and Peyton Thorne looking up the field, wide open for a touchdown for Javaris Johnson. A 28-yard touchdown pass. Way to answer the bell, this Auburn offense.
We're tied with 6:36 to go in the third. And Alex McPherson is out to try and break the tie. Ooh, Peyton Thorne, a couple big passes to Javaris Johnson on that drive. There's the snap, there's the kick. And Auburn, for the second time today, has the lead. Both teams have scored on their first drives of the third quarter. Alabama settled for a field goal. Auburn puts it in the end zone. Peyton Thorne to Javaris Johnson. An officially 27-yard touchdown play. And we'll send it downstairs. Will Herring has this Cook's Pest Control sideline report.
Guys, during the cadence, they rolled the safety down to take away the edge. It appears as though we schemed them up, and they had no answer for Javaris in the flat on the wheel route. Whoever has the flat has also got to take the wheel route. Nobody took the flat, and therefore the wheel route was wide open.
Sun-South John Deere Drive Summary, Will, thank you for that report. 75 yards, 5 plays, 2 minutes and 36 seconds. Two big pass plays between Peyton Thorne and Javaris Johnson. The final, a 27-yard touchdown strike. And with 6:36 to go in the third quarter, Auburn has a 1-point lead. Sun-South John Deere, preferred tractor of the Tigers. Find your local dealer at sunsouth.com. Former Auburn basketball player Gary Godfrey, former Alabama football player Kerry Good, both battling ALS. Auburn and Alabama fans are going head-to-head in the Kerry and Gary Challenge, a fundraising battle to support families in the state of Alabama who are living with ALS. Donate at kgchallenge.com. Funds raised will help provide needed medical equipment, home accommodation, renovations, and care services for those right here in Alabama. Again, that's kgchallenge.com. Now, Paul Ellen with a check of the Yellowwood scoreboard.
You know, by now you think that all of the conference championship games might be set, but that may not be the case. 15th-ranked Arizona rolling over Arizona State is expected, 52-7 there in the third quarter there. But in the Apple Cup there at halftime, and it's tied, Washington State 14, Washington 14. Washington could be in a little trouble there if they wind up tied with Arizona. And who gets to play Oregon next week? We'll see. Other games of note, 21st-ranked Tennessee rolling over Vandy 31-10, middle in the third quarter. And BYU pulling away from number 20, Oklahoma State 24-13. That's a check of the Yellowwood scoreboard, Andy.
6:36 remaining in the third quarter here. On their feet, making some noise at Jordan-Hare Stadium. Auburn on top 21-20 in the 88th Iron Bowl. Kendrick Law, Roydell Williams at the goal line in the north end zone for Alabama. McPherson will kick this one away for the Tigers. And he booms it away. And Law will watch it go about 2 yards deep into the end zone. On the night, Jalen Milroe, 13 of 18, 209 yards and a touchdown. He's also run for 38 yards on the day. Well, when Auburn took a brief lead in the first quarter, Alabama immediately answered back. Alabama trails by a point now with 6:36 to go in the third quarter of play.
That was a great job by Auburn offense on that last series to answer the bell, but it all started with that third down play by Javaris Johnson running that option route, getting that big play over the middle.
Benson and Bond to the wide side of the field. Benson in motion now as Milroe looks to the Alabama boundary, double pump, rolls to the Auburn boundary, looks upfield, and he runs it. He's got a first down as he's run out of ball. He's still on the field and down to the Auburn 37-yard line. I thought he'd gone out of bounds. He did not.
It looked like his forward progress was going to take him out of bounds, but Milroe is a big, strong athlete, able to turn the corner and get upfield, gain of 38 yards on that run.
To the 38 of Auburn. Man, oh, man. First down at the Auburn 38-yard line from the right hash. Milroe brings a tight end, Nyblack, in motion to the Alabama boundary. The snap to Milroe. Drops to throw. With time, throws it. Pass is complete inside the 30 and out of bounds at the 23-yard line to Isaiah Bond.
It's about the third time they run that crossing route with Isaiah Bond coming across the middle. They run you on a wheel route to turn all your attention towards that, but then bring the underneath route for an easy gain for the Alabama offense.
To the Auburn 22-yard line. Alabama is chewing up yards in bunches right now. First and 10 for Alabama at the Auburn 22. Trips to the wide side of the field for the Crimson Tide. Chase McClellan flanks the quarterback Milrow. It's going to be Milrow on the carry. Milrow bounces to the outside, makes a move forward, gets inside the 20 to the 18-yard line. He's taken down by DJ James.
Initially, that play was defended really well. Ramiro, being a great athlete, was able to make the first guy miss, which I believe was Lawrence Johnson, and got outside right there and picked up a positive gain.
4 yards to the Auburn 18. As we approach the five-minute mark in the third quarter, Auburn 21, Alabama 20. Crimson Tide immediately trying to answer the Auburn touchdown. Second and 6 from the Auburn 18. Oots, the tight end outside the left tackle. Now a man goes in motion. Hand off to McClellan. Bounces to the outside, and he's taken down at the 15. DJ James was there, so was Asante. It's a 3-yard gain, so was Nixon. Good coverage by Auburn. As we pause 10 seconds for station identification, this is the Iron Bowl on the Auburn Sports Network from Playfly. Third and 3 for Alabama from the Auburn 15. Law and Benson to the wide side of the field for the Crimson Tide. Bond in motion across the set on 3rd and 3. The snap to Milrow. With time, going to run. He's going to get the first down. He is down to the 10 and driven back. Flags are down, and this may be a block in the back on Alabama.
Yeah, blindside. Looks like a blindside block on Alabama right there on the receiver.
Maybe Kendrick Law that was the guilty party.
Carrying the run, personal foul, illegal blindside block. Offense number 13. 15-yard penalty from the spot of the foul. Repeat, 3rd down.
That was a first down carry for sure.
Yeah, Auburn doing a good job of getting pressure on Milrow in his second half of making him escape the pocket. But the problem is you lose containment. And with his athleticism, he's able to pick up positive yards with his feet. Got an opportunity right there for this Auburn defense because of that play, blindside block on Law.
7 of 12 tonight for Alabama. This is 3rd and 12 from the Auburn 24. From the left hash, short side of the field, the Alabama boundary. Milrow drops the throw. Plenty of time, throws it, and it's incomplete at the 10. Intended for number 11, Malik Benson, defended by DJ James.
DJ James showing up big in his second half, Andy. He had the big stop while ago on 3rd down. Now again on 3rd down in man coverage. He winning those one-on-one battles for DJ James.
This will be a field goal attempt of about 42 yards from Will Reichert. He is 6 of 8. In between 40 and 49 yards. This is about a 41 and a half yarder. Make it a 42 yarder from the left hash to give Alabama the lead. Snap is down. Kick is on the way by Reichert. And the kick is no good. He missed wide right.
Great pressure by Auburn defense on field goal block to push that kick to the right. We saw this in the Cal game. We traveled out west, forcing them to miss field goals. Another great miss right there for Bama, created by the Auburn pressure up front.
3:33 to go in the third quarter. Auburn 21, Alabama 20. And for the first time, Auburn on offense has a lead to work with. Damari Alston is the tailback. Peyton Thorne, the quarterback. He's thrown for 64 yards alone in the third quarter. First down for Auburn at its own 24. Thorne brings a man in motion. Hands the ball to Damari Alston off the right side. Damari Alston puts the head down. He gets out to the 28-yard line. Some pushing and shoving going on right now. It's a gain of four on the play by Damari Austin, who's had a really nice Iron Bowl. His eighth carry unofficially for 77 yards on the evening.
Key for Auburn offense in the second half, Andy, has been we'll be able to pick up positive yards on first down. We're not going backwards. We're going forward.
Second down from the 27 for Auburn. Austin flanks Thorne to his left from the right hash mark. Thorne is going to run it right up the middle. Thorne on the carry, head down across the 40. First down, Auburn. Terry and Arnold with the stop. First down of 14 yards for Peyton Thorne.
Great block by Avery Jones in that center position to help open up that hole for Peyton Thorne, running between him and Gunnar Britton on that left side of the football, creating a big run for Peyton Thorne.
Out to the 41-yard line for the Tigers. First down for Auburn. Clock rolls down, 2:26 in the third quarter. Auburn with a 21-20 lead. First down from the 41-yard line. Play clock is at 9 as Auburn comes to the line of scrimmage. Down to 4. Man in motion. The snap to Thorne. Play action. Makes one man miss. Rolls to the Auburn boundary. Throws. Pass complete. Javarius Johnson at the 48-yard line.
Great job of Peyton Thorne. Staying patient. Had the play action.
He made Dallas Turner miss.
Made Dallas Turner run. The sack leader for Bama. Completion of 7 yards.
Second down and 3 for Auburn. The snap to Thorne. Handoff. Damari Austin across midfield to the 48 of Alabama. And that's enough for an Auburn first down.
Right now,
we approach the 140 mark of the third.
Right now, this Auburn offense has Bama on their heels. They're not sure what's coming at them. We're hitting them on the edge. We're hitting them with the quarterback through the middle. We got option routes by the receivers on the outside. Right now, this offense is in rhythm and moving very fast.
The T is the Auburn tailback. On first down from the Alabama 48. From the left hash mark. Camden Brown, the lone receiver, split to the wide side of the field. The snap to Thorne. Hands the ball. No, but it's Thorne off the right side. Thorne close to the 45-yard line. Gives him 3 yards on the play. Again, in that RPO game, boy, a couple times we've seen Auburn hands it to the tailback going left. Jason, it could be big, big yardage.
Yeah, that was another opportunity for Brian Battee. If he hands that ball off again, we've outflanked their defense on the edge because they're trying to pay attention to inside. Almost been another big play for Auburn.
Alston, who has 80 yards back in the game, a tailback for the Tigers. Second and 7 from the Alabama 45. Thorne again moves forward inside the 40 to the 39-yard line. That should be enough for an Auburn first down. Going to be maybe a half-yard shot. So it's third and less than a yard for Auburn, right back to the line of scrimmage. Thorne from the gun, turns, hands the ball. Alston forward, first down for Auburn. Damari Alston with the big carry for the Tigers.
This offensive line got confidence. You see Connor Britton and Dylan Wade and Avery Jones and Jeremiah Wright, Tutal Miller. We're going to take this thing in the fourth quarter, Andy, with a one-point lead.
Listen to the roar at Jordan-Hare. Nobody gets you closer to the game than SiriusXM SEC Radio. Hear live games, news, analysis, and more. Visit SiriusXM.com to start listening. We go to the fourth in the Iron Bowl. Auburn on the move. First and 10 at the Alabama 36. Tigers 21, Alabama 20. This is the Auburn Sports Network from PlayFly.
Southeastern Industrial Contractors offers the path to a productive and successful career for hard workers of all ages, especially young people looking to jump straight into the workforce. Southeastern Industrial Contractors is now hiring for great-paying, skilled trade positions. Managing partner Derek Harville is a proud Auburn University graduate with deep roots in the community. Give him a call at 334-209-6355 to learn more. Southeastern Industrial Contractors, 334-209-6355.
Life isn't made for joint or orthopedic pain. It's made for living, for family, for your favorite hobbies, for sports, for morning walks and afternoon playing in the park. If you suffer from joint or orthopedic pain, turn to the experts at the Orthopedic Clinic. Our board-certified surgeons provide cutting-edge surgical procedures and high-quality, innovative services all close to home. Don't let joint or orthopedic pain keep you from doing all the things you love. Visit theorthoclinic.com and schedule an appointment today.
Earn more on your balances with the Max Elevate Money Market. Enjoy the competitive rate benefits of certificate accounts with no fixed terms and more flexibility. Earn more on your balances and access them anytime. You expect more, and Max delivers. See our amazing rates at mymax.com/elevate. Max, smart money made simple. Federally insured by NCUA. Certain restrictions apply.
Fine dining meets Southern comfort at Vintage 2298, Auburn's newest fine dining restaurant and butcher shop. Chef Randall Baldwin and wife Laura present Gulf cuisine with a Southern flair made fresh farm to table. Seasonal meats, cheeses, wine, and handcrafted cocktails available next door at the butcher shop. Manager Stephen Jacobs and staff bring a new level of service to local dining at Vintage 2298. Private dining and event space available, as well as awesome tailgate packages found in the butcher shop. Experience Vintage 2298.
Can there be Jordan-Hare magic tonight? We'll see as we go to the fourth quarter. Auburn wins the third quarter 7-3. Each team had the ball twice. Alabama made a field goal, missed a field goal. Auburn with a touchdown drive, and the Tigers have it in Alabama territory as we move to the fourth. This game recap sponsored by Wind Creek Casino and Hotel. With three Alabama locations in Atmore, Montgomery, and Wetumpka, you can escape every day at Wind Creek Casino and Hotel and at windcreekcasino.com. The stats about even for the third quarter, but Auburn has found some things that work. The big play, well, a third and three, Thorne with a 37-yard pass to Javarius Johnson. Thorne followed that up on the same drive with a 27-yard touchdown pass. And we go to the fourth with Auburn leading 21-20 and the Tigers in Alabama territory across the 40. Here with your fourth quarter story is Andy Burcham.
All right, Paul, thank you very much. First and 10 for the Tigers at the Alabama 36 after the light show going into the fourth quarter play, as if this crowd needed something else to cheer about. Auburn 21, Alabama 20. Damari Alston is the tailback, flanking Peyton Thorne. Auburn from the left hash mark. Javarius Johnson in the slot along with Rivaldo Fairweather to the short side of the field. Coy Moore in the slot to the wide side of the field for Auburn. Now Johnson comes in motion. Thorne up the middle. Peyton Thorne hit hard at the 32-yard line and taken down on the play. Number 32, Deontay Lawson, the redshirt sophomore out of Mobile, with the stop. It's a gain of four, though. Second and six from the 32.
Great job of Peyton picking up positive yards there with Malachi Moore coming off the edge.
From the left hash mark, Luke Deal in motion. Thorne out of the gun. Damari Alston bounces to the outside, gets to the 30, gets 2 yards on the play. It's going to bring up third down and four for Auburn.
Patient running by Damari Alston on that play behind Dylan Wade and Gunnar Britton. A shoestring tackle away from springing that one forward.
Ashford is the quarterback now, and he will flank to the left because Jarquez Hunter is in the Wildcat for the Tigers on third and a four. Ashford is in the slot along with Rivaldo Fairweather to the Alabama boundary. Now Ashford comes in motion. It's the pitch to Ashford. He makes the cut, and Ashford is taken down about 2 yards shy of the first down. And now a question for Auburn. Do you go for it on fourth down and one, or do you kick the field goal and increase your lead?
I think they're going for it. They're looking, they're bringing in Thorne back in the game, Javarius Johnson and Malcolm Johnson. Auburn's trying to go and take this game.
Thorne, the quarterback. Jarquez, the tailback. Fourth and to two for Auburn from the right hash. Javarius Johnson in motion. And movement by Auburn. Nope, they're gonna throw down the sideline. And it's incomplete. There was double movement by Auburn. Now let's see who this penalty's against.
I believe it's a free play, Andy. Once our guys moved in motion to shift, Alabama came across the line, and you taught to snap the ball when that happens.
The Auburn sideline certainly thinks that this is going to be a penalty against Alabama. It would give Auburn a first down.
My only question is that when you do shift, your guys are not set as well. Even though they jumped across the line, I'm not sure how the refs are going to call this one.
Auburn coaches are all pointing first down. We await the call from Jason Autry.
But you're taught as a center, once they jump across to snap it,
Well, that's a long time to talk about this call.
It all depends if they jump before.
Here's the call.
Offside, defense. 5-yard penalty results in the first down.
So, Andy, they got the jump on the right side of the defensive front for Alabama before our tight end shift. That's how come we won that call.
All right. First and 10, Auburn at the Alabama 23. Ashford is the Auburn quarterback. Jarquez Hunter, the Auburn tailback. Javarius Johnson, Rivaldo Fairweather split to the Alabama boundary. Brandon Frazier is the tight end outside the left tackle. Wide side of the field is the Alabama boundary. Fairweather comes in motion. Ashford's going to run it. Tries to bounce it to the outside, and he's taken down at the 31. But that was a great defensive play by Caleb Downs. Yeah, he fought the block and made the tackle.
Yeah, Jarquez trying to help seal the edge on that play. And Robbie's trying to get outside of him. But Andy, you called it. It's just a heads-up play by Caleb Downs to not allow Jarquez to seal him on the edge.
7-yard loss back to the 30. Second and 17 for Auburn. Thorne checks back in at quarterback for the Tigers. From the left hash, Jarquez in motion out of the backfield to the Alabama boundary. The snap to Thorne. He's going to run it. Thorne to the 25, 20, 15. He's to the 10. He stays to the 7. First and goal for Auburn. The Tigers are in the Chick-fil-A red zone. On the quarterback draw, 23 yards by Peyton Thorne.
Great play call right there by the Auburn offense. You caught Alabama sleeping a little bit, playing zone defense, but preparing for a pass. And then you sneak the quarterback right between the center of Avery Jones, Jeremiah Wright, and Gunnar Britton for a huge game for this Auburn offense.
Luke Keel checks into the game. Javarius Johnson back into the game for Auburn. First and goal from the 8 for the Tigers. Right hash mark. Deal is the H-back. Hunter is the tailback to the left. Man in motion. Jarquez Hunter finds a hole. Puts his head down. He gets inside the 5. Great run by Jarquez Hunter. Moving to his right. Now mark him down at the 5-yard line. Second and goal from the 5 for Auburn. 21-20, Tigers on top. Clock rolling down, 11:22 to go in the fourth quarter of the 88th Iron Bowl.
Yeah, we said get it to the fourth quarter. That's exactly where it's at. But this team is playing with so much confidence.
Trips to the wide side of the field for Auburn. A pair of backs or Deal is split wide right. Now Hunter back into the backfield. The snap to Thorne. Looks, he throws to the back of the end zone. In and out of the hand of Javarius Johnson. Coverage by Caleb Downs.
Yeah, I thought that was a great throw by Thorne, putting that ball high where only Javarius Johnson can come down with it on the back line. Almost had that one for a touchdown for Auburn. What we do on third down.
Third and goal from the 5 for the Tigers. Peyton Thorne, the offense, look to the boundary. Thorne walks to the line of scrimmage. Play clock at 11. Thorne may work under center. He pushes Hunter into the backfield. Play clock at 5. Thorne is under center. Turns, hands the ball, Jarquez Hunter. Jarquez Hunter forward, gets to about the 3, and he's pushed back. Ball is loose. Alabama comes out of the pile with the ball, but he was ruled down. And now a field goal attempt by Alex McPherson. And this will be a 22-yarder.
Auburn played that one a little safe right there, making sure we didn't do anything to turn that ball over, but make sure we keep points on the board in this situation.
A 21-and-a-half-yard field goal attempt inside the right hash by McPherson. Snap down, kick on the way, and it is good. McPherson, 13 of 13 this season. A school record 19 straight made field goals, increases Auburn's lead. With 10:15 to go in the fourth, how many defensive stands are left in this Auburn defense? Auburn 24, Alabama 20.
Southeastern Industrial Contractors offers the path to a productive and successful career for hard workers of all ages, especially young people looking to jump straight into the workforce. Southeastern Industrial Contractors is now hiring for great-paying, skilled trade positions. Managing partner Derek Harville is a proud Auburn University graduate with deep roots in the community. Give him a call at 334-209-6355 to learn more. Southeastern Industrial Contractors, 334-209-6355.
Hey Auburn fans, it's Coach Freeze. Few plays are more exciting than the sack. For every Auburn sack this season, philanthropic support from our fans will help the Ascension St. Vincent's Foundation invest in recreational equipment for schools around the state. Cultivating a healthy lifestyle early prevents chronic diseases. Please join Jill and me by making a donation to SAC Childhood Obesity. Visit stvhsfoundation.org, War Eagle.
The sweet smell of victory and grilled burgers still hang in the air. Your tailgate was a big win thanks to your Ford F-150 truck. With available Pro Power onboard, you used your F-150 as a mobile generator. That kept the celebration going long after the final whistle. See your local Ford dealer for great offers on a Ford F-150, the official truck of the Auburn Tigers. See owner's manual for important operating instructions.
The game has changed, and the future of Auburn athletics now demands a strong NIL program. I'm Jason Campbell. Let's come together, Auburn family, and make a lasting impact. Visit OwnToVictory.com. Every dollar you contribute to Own to Victory helps create NIL opportunities for our student athletes. Visit www.OwnToVictory.com and be a part of changing the game for Auburn athletics.
Ten 15 in the fourth, Auburn 24, Alabama 20. Sun South John Deere Drive summary. 72 yards, 16 plays. The longest drive for Auburn this season of 8 minutes and 18 seconds. A McPherson 21-yard field goal. Sun South John Deere, preferred track for the Tigers. Find your local dealer at sunsouth.com. The kickoff, 4 yards deep into the end zone. And has there been a bigger defensive series coming up than this one right now for Auburn in the Iron Bowl with 10:15 to go in the fourth quarter and the Tigers leading highly favored Alabama 24-20.
You're right, Andy. You don't want to get this Alabama offense life in this second half. And what they was doing a little bit in the first half. The second half, we made some adjustments where we've kind of made Milroe uncomfortable in the pocket where he's been indecisive whether to run or to throw it, which is going to cause some indecision for their offense.
First down from the 25. Roydell Williams is the tailback. Alabama scrimmages from the left hash mark. Play action by Milroe. Rolls to his right. Gets some pressure. Milroe gets away. Taken down. Eugene Asante took him down at the line of scrimmage.
Eugene Asante, what an athlete himself. You know this guy can run from sideline to sideline. He's a spy guy that they use on Jalen Milroe because they're both great athletes. It's who's going to win the one-on-one battles. Eugene Asante on that one got the better hand.
No gain on the play. Second and 10. From the right hash mark now for the Crimson Tide. Milroe from the gun. Roydell Williams flanks him to the left. Now moves to the right side as they bring Utes the tail or the tight end outside the left tackle. Play action by Milroe with pressure. Throws it up the seam. Downfield incomplete. Incomplete, intended for the tight end, Amari Niblack. It was Nehemiah Pritchett and DJ James, or excuse me, Zion Puckett for Auburn. Third and 10 for the Crimson Tide.
Great job by Zion Puckett and Nehemiah Pritchett on that play because the one thing that Zion didn't do, even though the tight end didn't catch the ball, he didn't clean him up, which would have caused the penalty. Great smart play by Zion Puckett as well.
Alabama, 6 of 13 on third down tonight. This is third and 10 from the 25 for the Crimson Tide. Auburn puts 5 at the line of scrimmage, rushes 4. To the sideline, it is caught. A first down catch by Jermaine Burton.
It's gonna be close.
No, he's out of bounds. He was ruled out of bounds. Incomplete, incomplete.
Burton left toe looked like it touched the line when he came down with that catch. Alabama's going to try to go quickly, but they call this incomplete.
It's fourth down. It's a three and out. It's our first three and out of the night for the Auburn defense.
Rolling of a receiver.
Three and out tracker.
The game possession is under video review. Timeout.
Three and out tracker driven by Truckworks, official commercial truck dealer of the Auburn Tigers. Remember, the call is incomplete. Is there conclusive evidence that his foot came down in bounds? It is close.
It's about as close as you get. You talk about a game of inches. This is a play of inches on this play.
Replay reviews are brought to you by Auburn's Houston Clinic. Don't let a sports injury bench you this season. Go to the Houston for your fracture, sprain, or strain, because orthopedics is all they do. Go straight to the specialist. Go to Auburn's Houston Clinic. It is very close. We get a pretty good view from that sideline. Boy, and it, if his foot isn't out of bounds, it's barely in bounds. That's how close it is.
Well, the great thing for Auburn is the initial call on the field is incomplete, right. So it has to be inconclusive evidence.
It was originally ruled complete, but the official that came up the sideline said no, he was out of bounds.
And it's a little blurry on the TV screen when they show his foot touching the ground. It's hard to tell.
Boy, it's close. It is close. This could go either way, friends. It's a really good catch by Burton. The question is, did he get his toe down in bounds?
Burton has been their go-to receiver in this game today.
Four catches, 107 yards for Jermaine Burton and a touchdown. Boy, is this an enormous review in this game with 9:20 to go in the fourth quarter and Auburn on top 24-20.
You're right, and it's about as close as it gets.
And as you might guess, they are taking their time with this review.
Meanwhile, we've done a great job of this second half on Milroe of giving him opportunity.
The review continues. The referee, Jason Autry, talking with the folks in Birmingham. I believe there is a review crew here as well. The Auburn fans are convinced he was out of bounds, as you would guess. And we're going to get the call coming up from Jason Autry.
After video review, the ruling on the field stands. Incomplete pass.
Didn't have enough evidence.
Auburn gets a three and out. And to this point, the biggest defensive stand of the night for Auburn.
That's why the call on the field is very important, because if you don't have inconclusive evidence, you cannot change the call on the field.
James Burnett to punt it away. Keontae Scott for Auburn is back near the Auburn 30-yard line. 9:20 to go in the fourth. Auburn 24, Alabama 20. The snap to Burnett. He gets it away. And a boomer. Keontae Scott back at the 17-yard line up the Alabama boundary. Makes a man miss. Trying to get to the Auburn sideline and taken down at the 22-yard line. That was Quindarius Robinson that made the stop.
It was getting chippy on the
plane.
And
the flag has been thrown. A 56-yard punt. You cannot lose your composure. You can't lose your composure. And again, we await the call from Jason Autry. 9:06 to go in the fourth. Auburn 24, Alabama 20.
Right at the start of fourth quarter, Andy, it got really chippy down there between the 50-yard line, and it's continued so far. What you expect in the Iron Bowl, but like you say, we have to keep our composure.
There is no foul in the play. The result is first down for Auburn. Timeout.
9:06 to go. Auburn ball, first and 10. When we return, Tigers 24, Alabama 20. This is the Auburn Sports Network from Playfly.
It takes hard work to be the best in the game. Planning, commitment, resilience, sweat.
That's why Old Dominion Freight Line, the number one national LTL carrier for quality, works hard to be the best in the game and is proud to support those striving to be the best in theirs. Old Dominion Freight Line, official freight carrier of Auburn Athletics, helping the world keep promises.
Do you say War Eagle instead of hello? See tigers in the clouds? Never wear crimson and white together? If so, there's no better way to show your tiger pride than with the Auburn University Regents Visa debit card and prepaid Regents Now card. As passionate as you are about Auburn, Regents is even more passionate about celebrating your every financial win and helping you plan for the next one. To order your card, visit Regents.com/GoTigers. Regents, official bank of the SEC, member FDIC. Terms, conditions, and fees apply.
Yellowwood knows that a five-star backyard is the place to make lasting memories. Like cookouts. Cornhole with friends. Ooh, a neighborhood potluck with your wife's pasta salad. The one with the feta. Oh, sorry. Or taking a nap on your deck in a hammock. Naps are memories. I love naps. For five-star backyards and the most memorable experiences, Yellowwood brand pressure-treated pine. If it doesn't have that yellow tag, you don't want it.
Are you looking to advance your career without putting your life on hold? Consider the flexibility of an online MBA at Auburn University's Harvard College of Business. Ranked among the nation's best by U.S. News and World Report, our 100% online MBA program provides the flexibility you need to pursue a degree while maintaining your personal and professional life. Learn more at harvard.auburn.edu.
.06 to go in the fourth. Auburn 24, Alabama 20. Auburn first and 10 at its own 22-yard line. A reminder to you, that last field goal drive by Auburn was 8 minutes and 18 seconds long. It's the longest offensive drive of the season for Auburn. There is 9:06 left in the fourth quarter right now. Thorne from the gun inside the left hash mark. Jarquez Hunter is the tailback. Brings a man in motion. Thorne hands the ball to Jarquez. Cuts upfield, Jarquez out to the 25, bang down at the 26-yard line by Deontay Lawson. 6 yards on the gain for Jarquez Hunter out to the 26-yard line.
I like the positive plays by Auburn on first down. When we get the ball going forward rather than backwards on some of those reverses, we've lost yardage. But in these situations, we've done a really good job of getting positive yards.
Second down from the 26 for Auburn at the right hash mark. Hunter goes in motion to the Auburn boundary. Thorne from the right hash mark. There's the snap to Payton. It's going to be a quarterback draw for Thorne. Thorne across the 30. He's got a first down. He's run out of bounds at the 35. 9 yards on the first down carry for Payton Thorne. Hunter, 93 yards. Alston, 85 yards. And Payton Thorne is now above. He's at 76 yards. Auburn has rushed for 263 yards tonight. First down for Auburn at the 35-yard line. We approach the 8-minute mark in the fourth quarter. Thorne from the right hash. Double receivers to the right. Thorne wants to run it, and he's taken down at the line of scrimmage. They try and strip it away from him. And he is taken down on the play by Tim Smith. The officials talk with Smith. It's going to be second and 10 for Auburn.
One thing as well, Andy, this is against a defense that only allowed 117 yards average per game in their opponent's rushing.
They gave him a yard, second and 9 for Auburn. We approach 7.5 minutes to go in the fourth quarter. The Tigers lead by 4, 24-20 on second and 9 from the Auburn 36. Fairweather and Riley to the short side of the field. Double receivers to the right. And now Jarquez Hunter in the slot. The snap to Thorne, drops the throw. Looks, he throws up the seam. It is caught and dropped by Fairweather at midfield. He had it, it was ripped out of his hands. Jihad Campbell with the defensive play for Alabama.
What a great throw by Payton, sitting in the pocket on that, making an accurate pass over the middle to big Rivaldo Fairweather.
Right back to the line of scrimmage, Auburn. Third and 9 for the Tigers. Thorne from the gun, empty set, rolls out of the pocket, and he's in trouble. And Thorne will go down back at the 31. the quarterback sack to Chris Braswell, his eighth sack of the season.
That's what you call a coverage sack, looking downfield, trying to find someone. Alabama secondary did a good job on that play of covering our receivers. Man, that second down catch would have been huge. Rivaldo Fair would have took a big hit.
Caleb Downs back at the Alabama 25 to take this punt from Oscar Chapman. How about a boomer? Oscar rolls to his left, kicks it away. It's a good one. It sends Downs back to the 15, and Downs is taken down at the 18. Terrific coverage by Jalen Simpson on the play. SeatGeek, now the official ticketing partner of Auburn Athletics. Whether you're buying or selling football tickets, SeatGeek is the place to do it. SeatGeek, so Tiger fans can fan. The clock is stopped with 6:19 to go. Alabama first and 10 at its own 18 after a 53-yard punt. The third 50-yarder of the night and the 47th in the career of Oscar Chapman. Auburn 24, Alabama 20. Auburn football continues in a moment.
The Whataburger Jalapeno Cheddar Biscuit is back. But some folks have yet to try it. So let's not do the thing where we're like, you've never had a jalapeno cheddar biscuit before? You know what? It's okay. Let's just invite them to try this flaky, cheesy, and slightly spicy goodness for themselves. The Jalapeno Cheddar Biscuit, available as a sandwich or on its own from 11 p.m. to 11 a.m. for a limited time at participating locations. Whataburger, just like you like it.
You've created a comfortable home office. Now let Carrier provide the cash bonus. For a limited time, you can claim up to $1,550 in cool cash rebates on a qualified Carrier home comfort system. There's never been a better time to upgrade to year-round premium comfort and energy savings.
Carrier, a proud partner of Auburn Athletics and special needs assistance stations for you. Turn to the experts with Carrier.
Who out there likes to eat chicken? Did you know that when it comes to chicken production, Alabama rules the roost? In fact, we're ranked second in the country in broiler production. That's meat-type chickens, with nearly 2,600 poultry farm families raising more than a billion birds a year. Alabama's poultry industry adds more than $15 billion a year to the state's economy and provides jobs for almost 90,000 Alabamians. So be sure to prepare your favorite chicken dish this football season.
After the game, catch the Regions Bank postgame show. We'll have locker room interviews with players, assistants, and head coach Hugh Freeze, plus scores, highlights, and analysis, all on the Regions Bank postgame show. Show your Tiger pride and get a win for your wallet with the Auburn University Regions Visa debit card and the prepaid Regions Now card. Order now at regions.com/GoTigers.
This broadcast of the Auburn-Alabama game is presented by Coca-Cola. They say Coke Zero Sugar is irresistibly tasty. Does that make it the best Coke ever? Find out for yourself. Now, back to more of the Iron Bowl from Jordan-Hare Stadium.
First down for Alabama from its own 18. Ball in the middle of the field. Play action, Milrow to the boundary. The pass is complete. A couple yards gain, and that is about all to number 17, Isaiah Bond. Clock rolls down, 6:06 and counting in the fourth. Auburn by four in the 88th Iron Bowl, a three-yard gain, second and seven from the right hash mark to the Alabama 21. Alabama coming out of the Auburn student section. I don't think anybody's gone home tonight. Auburn didn't have a turnover last week. How about another one right here? Handoff, tailback, up the middle. And McClellan is taken down at the 24. And this will be third and five for Alabama. Marcus Harris with the stop. Make it third and four, Alabama. Yeah.
Marcus Harris and Justin Rogers done a really good job in the second half of playing that defense line of scrimmage against Alabama's run game. Big third down play for this Auburn defense coming up.
Milrow, 8 of 17 since the first quarter. This is third and four from the 24. Milrow, two throw. Milrow in some trouble. Milrow goes down, he flipped it out. That ball goes out of bounds. That may have been a lateral. Keldrick Buck got to Milrow. Incomplete pass.
How about Jalen McLeod, the transfer from App State, continued on his rush, slipped down initially, got back up, and was able to trip up Milroe to force an errant pass. Andy, this defense in the second half has put Milroe in some uncomfortable positions, and it's paying off.
Back-to-back three and outs by the Auburn defense. Three and out tracker driven by Truckworks, official commercial truck dealer of the Auburn Tigers. 4:58 to go in the fourth. Burnett to punt it away. Keontae Scott back. Burnham gets it away. Keontae Scott calls for the fair catch. Oh, and goes down. He fumbled, and the ball is loose, and Alabama has it. But may be ruled down. It may be ruled down. Alabama has the ball in the end zone. You can't advance it, but Alabama's going to get it on the fumble by Keontae Scott. He lost his balance calling for the fair catch.
Brug on the field as the punt was first touched by the receiving team, recovered by the kicking team. By rule, it's dead when recovered by the kicking team. First down, Alabama at that spot.
Jihad Campbell picked it up. My goodness gracious.
That's the only thing that could help this Alabama team was self-inflicted wounds right there on that play. Keontae, a great punt returner. Just like you said, and he lost his foot, and when that ball, he caught it, but with the ball, when he hit the ground, he couldn't control it. Alabama was able to recover it.
Alabama first and 10 at the Auburn 30. Gotta recover. Gotta recover. From the left hash mark. Kendrick Locke sets up outside the right tackle. Tailback goes in motion out of the backfield. Milroe flushed out of the pocket's gonna run it. He is to the 25-yard line, up the boundary and out of bounds near the 20, and a first down for Alabama. They will give him the first down at the Auburn 19 and a half.
At that time, we did not spy on Milroe. First down play, we're thinking probably run or some form of short passing game. So we decided not to spy. And he's able to scramble out to the right and pick up a huge game for this Bama offense.
First down to the Auburn 19-yard line for Alabama. Double receivers to the short side of the field. Now in motion near side, handoff, tailback. McClellan driven down or brought down from behind on the play by Jalen McLeod at the 20-yard line. He's going to lose a yard. Second and 11 for the Crimson Tide. The clock rolls down to the four-minute mark of the fourth quarter.
Jalen McLeod showing up big here in his fourth quarter. Coming off the edge. This is a game right here, Andy. You can either create a legacy for yourself or be cemented for history.
Roydell Williams is the tailback. Flanking Jalen Milroe, ball in the middle of the field. Second and 11 from the Auburn 20 for the Crimson Tide. Low snap to Milroe. In the pocket. He goes down at the 31. Marcus Harris.
Marcus Harris beating his guy up front. Tyler Booker trying to block Marcus Harris. A tackle and a loss for 9 yards created a third and long situation for this Bama offense.
Third and a 20. Alabama needs to get to the Auburn 9. Clock rolls down. 3:05 and counting. It's third and 29. Third and 20 from the 29 for Alabama. Milroe from the gun. He's going to throw it. Milroe pressured. Gets away from one man. Cuts it to the outside. Milroe to the 20. Milroe taken down at the 10. Nehemiah Pritchett with the stop. And Milroe, I think, is shy of the first down by about a yard. And Pritchett is down on the play. Milroe got 19 of the 20 yards he needed. And Pritchett is lying on his back after the stop. And it's going to bring up fourth down and one for Alabama with 2:38 to go in the fourth quarter. Auburn got the pressure on Milroe, but he stepped up into the pocket, and then he got the 19 yards before he was taken down by Nehemiah Pritchett. And Auburn's medical staff is on that sideline trying to help Nehemiah Pritchett. Fourth and one for Alabama at the Auburn 10, 2:38 in the fourth. Auburn 24, Alabama 20. This is the Auburn Sports Network from Playfly.
Eagle 102.3 is your East Alabama and Midwest Georgia's country music leader,
playing the top hits from the hottest artists.
Download our Eagle 102.3 app so you can listen to us whenever and wherever. Listen to your favorite country artists, stay up to date on your favorite college football team,
War Eagle,
and catch our local high school football broadcast, all from our app. Available on Apple and the Google Play Store. For more information, visit our website, eagle1023.com, or find our link tree on Instagram at WELR Eagle.
We've all been caught up in the little chores that pile up every day. The dishes in the sink, the trash that needs taking out, the pesky check engine light. Isn't it time to make a change and escape to a whole new world of possibilities? Where there's dinner without dishes, nights filled with adventure, and every day you feel like a winner. A little change can go a long way when you escape every day at Wind Creek Casino and WindCreekCasino.com.
Yellowwood knows that a five-star backyard is the place to make lasting memories. Like roasting marshmallows on a cool fall night. That's it. Turn it nice and slow. Get it toasted all... Oh, no, it's on fire. Oh, you want it on fire. Okay, that's a choice, I guess. Crunchy. For five-star backyards and the most memorable experiences, Yellowwood brand pressure-treated pine. If it doesn't have that yellow tag, you don't want it.
When the game goes into overtime. But the game goes into overtime. The choice to enjoy is easy. Bud Light, easy to drink, easy to enjoy. Order Bud Light online today. Enjoy responsibly. Anheuser-Busch Bud Light Beer, St. Louis, Missouri.
.38 in the fourth. Alabama fourth and one at the Auburn at 10. Nehemiah Pritchett was able to walk off the field under his own power. Ball just inside the 10-yard line for Alabama. They need maybe a half yard to keep this drive alive. Auburn 24, Alabama 20.
Big guys in the middle, got to get big on this play.
Alabama has its heavy set. Milroe is under center. On fourth and one. Milroe under center. Play clock at 19. Milroe pitches the ball. Roydell Williams has the first down to the 8-yard line. Roydell Williams going right. First and goal for Alabama. And Jalen McLeod comes off the field holding his left shoulder. First and goal for Alabama at the 7. And Jalen McLeod couldn't even get off the field. He is holding his left shoulder. And Elijah McAllister comes in to replace Jalen McLeod. 1:58 to go in the fourth. Auburn 24, Alabama 20. A fumbled punt by Auburn has given Alabama new life, and it's first and goal for Alabama at the Auburn 7-yard line.
These guys are leaving it all out on the field tonight, Andy. This defense trying to get big in the trenches right here in this situation.
McLeod walks off the field under attention from the Auburn medical staff. Alabama first and goal from the Auburn 7 from the right hash mark. Is there one more defensive stand for this Auburn team? Jalen Milroe, by the way, 335 of Alabama's 439 yards offense by the Alabama quarterback, either on the ground or through the air. First and goal for Alabama at the 7. 1:58 to go in the fourth. Alabama 3 timeouts, Auburn 2.
You got to expect Alabama to probably try to go behind that big offensive line in this situation. But our defensive front, Marcus Harris and Jason Jones and Justin Rogers and those guys have done a really good job in this second half of containing that line of scrimmage. But Andy, in a game like this, you work on this all the time in practice. Yeah. Within the 10-yard line, ones versus ones, and who wants it most? We're about to find out here in this situation.
Jermaine Burton gets single coverage on the wide side of the field to the Auburn boundary from DJ James. Ball at the right hash. Roydell Williams with the carry, taken down from behind. Austin Keyes got him. Clock rolling down. Clock stopped with a minute 43 in the fourth quarter.
Austin Keyes did a great job splitting right there between the right guard and center. Tackled him for a loss.
And I think Auburn called the timeout. Stopping the clock with 1:43 to go in the fourth. Second and eight, second and goal. The loss on the play. Second and goal for Alabama from the Auburn 8-yard line.
Yeah, Coach Freeze and his staff thinking in this situation, if Alabama scores, then we'll have one timeout to try to get in field goal range to tie it. But right now, we're trying not to look to tie it. He's called that timeout because they're trying to eliminate that situation.
Good news, Jalen McLeod back in the ballgame.
By stopping this Bama offense.
Second and goal from the eight for Alabama. Roydell Williams flanks Jalen Milroe. Ball between the hashes. Double wide receivers stacked up right and left in the slot for Alabama. Now Burton goes in motion. Low snap gets by Milroe. He picks it up and goes down at the 26. I'm not sure he was ready for the snap. Clock rolls down, 1:31 and counting.
He sure wasn't ready for the snap. You watch the replay. He's looking at the defense, still in his cadence. And that ball was snapped and went by him. Big break for this Auburn defense.
Third and goal now from the 26 for Alabama. Clock continues to roll down. 1:09 and counting. Third and goal from the 26. Benson, wide right, trips to the wide side of the field. That's the Auburn boundary. Now Nyblack in motion sets up in the slot. Third and goal from the 26. Milroe in the pocket. Still looking. Milroe bounces to his left. Milroe stops shy. Sets up and he throws to the end zone. Incomplete at the two. Incomplete intended for Benson. 43 seconds to go. Third and goal for Alabama. Caleb Wooden defending on the play. Third and goal from the 26. There is a flag on the other side of the field.
I think this flag is going to go against Alabama. He was crossed the line of scrimmage again, Andy.
Well, that's a loss of down. It is fourth down, isn't it?
So this will be fourth and goal.
The indicators on the field still say third down. There is a flag down. We await the call.
Well, his entire body was past the line of scrimmage. It should be an illegal forward pass.
It is against Alabama. They're gonna mark it off.
The thing is, I guess they're asking the coach Saban if he wants a 10-second runoff.
The quarterback went beyond the line of scrimmage. Illegal forward pass. Offense number four. The penalty is 5 yards from the previous spot with a loss of down. Alabama has elected to use a timeout to avoid the 10-second runoff. Fourth down.
That's the first timeout for Alabama in the second half.
It's going to be a ball game on this play.
It'll be fourth and goal from the 31.
Everybody in here got to get on your feet and get loud.
The 88th Iron Bowl is coming down to fourth and goal from the 31-yard line for Alabama. And rather than taking the 10-second runoff, Alabama used its first timeout. They have two timeouts left. Auburn has one. All right, how do you defend it?
Yeah, you got to play your guys at the goal line, but you also got to put your linebackers in the middle because the effect of Milroe trying to run from this depth is not there. But you got to understand, he's going to try to buy time. The one thing that Auburn can't do is get a pass interference, right, Andy. That will get him an automatic first down.
That bails out Alabama if that happens.
But what a stand by this defense so far after that sudden change on the fumble punt. If they're able to hold this Alabama offense out of the game.
Fourth and goal from the 31 for Alabama.
Burton wide left. He's joined by Isaiah Bond. Double wide receivers right. One of those is Roydell Williams. And it will be an empty set on fourth and goal from the 31. And Auburn called a timeout. Its final timeout with 43 seconds remaining in the 88th Iron Bowl. And Auburn on top 24-20. It looked like Auburn was going to get the ball back with an opportunity to run out the clock. But as Keontae Scott came up to take the punt, he called for a fair catch. He lost his balance and fumbled it. And Alabama had first and goal from the 7, but have gone backwards since.
Yeah, that bad snap between Milrow and the center.
Now remember, they lost a yard on the first play.
Right, lost a yard on the first play. Tackle behind the line of scrimmage by Austin Keys.
Then the snap past Milrow, and then an illegal pass.
And I expect the Auburn to use a timeout in that situation because you want to see what the offense lines up in. And then once they line up in it, you take a timeout so you can go to the sideline and go through every scenario of what they might try to do in this situation.
Trips to the Auburn boundary, the wide side of the field. Double wide receivers right for Alabama. Burton and Williams. Empty backfield for Jalen Milrow on fourth and goal from the 31. Milrow to throw out of the shotgun with time. Still with time. He looks. He throws to the back of the end zone. It is caught for a touchdown. Isaiah Bond with the catch.
Andy, what they did was they gave him so much time in the pocket, it allowed Isaiah Bond to get to the back of the line against one-on-one against DJ. And all Milrow did was hold the rest of the defense with his eyes and throw the ball to the back line and let his guy go up and catch it because DJ couldn't get his head turned around. That's the only thing. I don't like rushing three in those situations, but that's just a great throw right there and a great catch by Isaiah Bunn. DJ was in right position. Just a tough break. But Auburn still.
Alabama 26, Auburn 24, pending the extra point by Will Reichard. On fourth and goal from the 31. My goodness gracious.
That's tough.
Bond caught it, got 2 feet down, as a matter of fact.
In this situation, Auburn probably on the sideline offensively trying to come up with a plan to figure out how you get 3 plays in.
Yeah, and Auburn doesn't have a timeout, remember.
To get the McPherson to have a shot. Andy, you say he can kick it from 58. We may need a 58 tonight to try to get out of this one.
Riker can make it a 3-point game with 32 seconds remaining in the fourth quarter. Snap down, the kick is on the way by Reichard, and Alabama has a 3-point lead with 32 seconds to go. Wait, Milrow just had plenty of time. Auburn didn't come close to getting to him, and he found Bond in the back of the back corner of the end zone.
Yeah, that's the danger of rushing 3 guys and dropping 8, because you know they try to create a one-on-one matchup. You know the middle field is going to be guarded, but they try to say, who can we attack on the outside in a one-on-one matchup? But Andy, the only way that allowed is you give them time to let those receivers get that deep in the end zone. He got to the back line and was able to pivot and run away from DJ a little bit.
32 seconds to go in the fourth quarter. 27-24, Alabama on top. Auburn does not have a timeout. Battee and Jarquez Hunter are back to take this kickoff from Reichard. I'll be honest, I don't know if he'll kick this as deep as he can. And if he does, Auburn needs just to call a fair catch to save the clock. Reichard kicks it off. Battee is 4 yards deep in the end zone. He'll bring it out to the 10, to the 15. Spins. And he's taken down at the 14. That took 6 seconds off the clock. And some pushing and shoving going on right now.
In that situation, you got to call fair catch and save the time. Time is the most important thing going on. There's a Can't tell if that's a flag on the field or someone's shoe. But Brian Battee has got to fair catch that ball. Get the ball at the 25-yard line and save the seconds on the clock.
Now the officials are talking. I've not seen a flag yet as a result of the pushing and shoving after the play.
First down, Auburn.
You talk about a difference between 10 yards starting off here.
Auburn at first and 10 at its own 15, 26 seconds to go, and Auburn needs to get about to its own 40 to have a shot at a field goal by McPherson. And it would be a long one at that. Thorne from the shotgun. The snap, they rush three. Thorne in trouble, loses the ball, it's in the end zone. Auburn recovers it. A lineman gets out of the end zone. Tuton Miller got it out of the end zone. And Auburn's got to quickly get to the line of scrimmage and down it, or the clock is going to run out.
That's the one thing that couldn't happen, was getting sacked.
It's down to three. It's down to two. It's down to one. This will be the final play. Thorne up the sideline, and the ball is intercepted by Terrion Arnold. And he's taken down, and he scores a touchdown, and that's how Alabama wins it.
You got to be kidding me. Kids fought hard.
Boy, that's just an absolute heartbreaker for this Auburn team. Alabama scores on fourth and goal from the 31 and then gets a pick six to end the game. And Alabama beats Auburn. Now, the scoreboard now says it's Alabama 27. Auburn 24, maybe he didn't get into the end zone. He stepped out. I guess it doesn't matter at this point.
Yeah, the one thing in that situation where you're trying to drive and get field goal range with no timeouts, you know they're going to bring that pressure. The one thing you can't allow in that situation is a sack. And once you get a sack, it's tough to get back and get regrouped with guys running down the field as far as our receivers was running.
Fourth and goal from the 31, Jalen Milroe to Isaiah Bond. And Alabama wins it. The final score, Alabama 27, Auburn 24. Stay tuned. Auburn football continues in a moment.
Thinking of advancing your career with a master's degree in business? If so, consider the graduate degree choices at Auburn University's Herbert College of Business. Ranked among the nation's best, we offer full-time and online programs in finance, supply chain management, information systems, accounting, and business administration. Learn more at harbert.auburn.edu.
Auburn family, let's be million-dollar game changers together. Help On to Victory hit 5,000 members by National Signing Day, December 20th, to unlock a $1 million